good game of football we're expecting today in the seniors in second division.
Yeah, I also looking at, we will too, exactly right, Tony Fu. One of the unsung heroes for Seville this year has been Andrew Davies at full back. He's just been sensational.
Oh,
player,
yeah,
hasn't
he has. Andrew Davies, and also the unsung young blokes today, and also just looking at the Seville side, and also you just cannot underestimate a South Belgrave come out onto the ground. Also, another bloke you can't underestimate is Lawrence Farmer up forward. If he gets on today, it could almost be a blowout.
Well, that's it. I think the key is no doubt that Winmar and Farmer hold the key up forward to this game. I think, yes, if they can be on, because we did that, as I mentioned before, when we were talking about Brett Fisher and Tony.
Yep.
The last time we fought, Farmer kicked 8 against South Belgrave, and also Winmar kicked 4 that day. But let's not say South Belgrave, as they come out in the ground, they're a very talented, even unit, aren't they?
Oh, yeah, they are.
They've got some strengths, good tools, and of course the three marshals. Now, Wayne Deegan is very good up forward, and also
2003 Commodore Prince Senior Division 2 Grand Final. Could you please remain standing for the playing of the National Anthem?
In the big one, the Division 2 Grand Final between South Belgrave and Seville. Umpire Lee Walters and Adam...
No, and Andy LaMercia.
Andy LaMercia, my apologies. Andy LaMercia will be in charge, so congratulations to those two as the players break up and head for their positions. And no doubt Seville will be kicking up towards the dog track end, because we see Nicky Winmar, Lawrence Farmer heading forward, also Mick Howard there with the white bandage around his knee, and also looks like Scotty Troyan will be going down there to centre half forward. And I'll get you, Brett, to look at the matchups early.
Yep.
Paul Marshall, I see here, looks like he will be starting up forward for South Belgrave. Just looking for Wayne Deegan, looks like he's starting in the middle there.
Yep.
Also Dustin Apps, Clint Lansbury, and Bryce Marshall look like they'll start in the middle. And Tony Fu in the middle for Seville will be
Scotty Wilson, also Troy Coates,
Kane Shaw,
also coming into the middle, also will be Ben Salter, or is he going up forward? He's going up forward. And also Jason Leeds is starting in the ruck for Seville.
Alright, we're just about ready for a start here. The ground is cleared and we're nearly ready in terrific conditions here. We're nearly ready for the Division 2 Grand Final, the big one. Looking forward, a big crowd here at the Hillsville ground.
Oh, it's a huge crowd at the moment.
It is really built up.
They're parked all around the swamp over there. They're parked up on the hill. The four-wheel drives are up on the hill, and a big crowd in front of the social rooms. As Lee Walters holds the ball up to start the big second division grand final between Seville and South Belgrave. Leeds, Apps goes over the top, gets first handle to Troy Coates, gets it on to Shane Senior. Seville go forward. Nicky Winmar's in there battling for the ball at the moment. But in there also is Stewie Boyce, but it comes out wide. It's picking the ball up is Shane Brockwell, playing across half back, but he's quickly smothered for it. Nicky Windmar's in there, gets a hand past the Farmer. Farmer, a little scrubby kick around the corner. First score of the grand final. 1 point to Lawrence Farmer. 1 point to Seville. They go on to one behind, leading South Belgrave yet to score. And that is on which scoreboard, Jeff?
On the Hoogies of Yarra Glen scoreboard.
Yarra Glen scoreboard. Thank you, Jeffrey. Brett, quick start to Seville.
Yes. You've got to get it moving. Like we said, it's not going to be pretty. It's just a couple of quick scrap kicks forward and then got opportunities to score.
Kicked out wide. Picked up and kicked out around the corner that time by Chris Koski. But it comes down to Dean Troyan. Goes out wide. Shane Sweeney's got a mountain of room. Kicks it long. Down towards the forward line. Down there, looking down there for, looked like it was some. Chris Doran down there at half forward. Comes in, picks the ball up. Chris Doran kicks the ball around the corner. Second point of the game to Seville. They go into two behinds, leading South Belgrave on no score.
Yeah, Seville into their forward line straight away. Two behinds. South Belgrave yet to get into their forward 50. All right, the kick out from full back from Alex Bacon to this grand final will go short. There he'll find Cody at half back for South Belgrave. He goes sideways out there. There, looking there for, that might be Beck. It's James Beck out there, does a round, picks it up. Oh, he's tackled there, good tackle, and he's been pinged there by the umpire. Great tackle there, and it will go to Troyan. That is Scott Troyan, a good tackle there at half forward, kicking down towards the Greyhound complex end in this first quarter. We've travelled about a minute and a half in this grand final, just holding it up. Scott Troyan on that outer side, just waiting. The lead's coming. Doran playing forward also. Chris Doran. Now it's going towards him. He pushes off his man. It'll spill though. South Belgrave to punt and by hands there to Brockwell. He's in trouble. Tackled by CJ Harrison. Quilty did well. Sideways out the leads. It went through his hands. Troyan will come in and support him, but a great tackle by Apps. And the umpire says, give it to me, fellas, and we'll have a ball up at half forward for Seville in this grand final. They lead two behinds to South Belgrave yet to score on the Hoogies of Yarra Glen scoreboard. Kick out from the South Belgrave half back line. We'll go out wide in front of the big crowd, in front of the club rooms over there, in front of Paul Marshall. It's out of bounds for a boundary throw in, centre wing on the outer side.
Boundary throw in, right in front of the social club at Hurlsville. Just waiting for the boundary umpire to get set. Jason Leeds up against Apps. This is where Leeds will come into it. Tap down. Great kick out of there by Seville, up towards half forward. Doran punched the ball away, waved the tackle straight away on his Belgrave opponent. Alex Bakens comes out, gets a hand pass off. Koski kicks the ball up. Apps taps the ball forward. Comes to Paul Marshall. He's matched up by Eddie Wells. Kick down forward. Rowan Marshall couldn't take the mark. He's playing on half forward at the moment. Looks like Rowan Marshall, but it goes over the boundary line out of bounds for a boundary throw in.
Any matchup you've noticed Brett Fisher at this stage?
Yep, he's just picked one up there, Fooey. Paul Marshall's playing on a half-forward flank on number 77, Eddie Wells. And we've got Bryce Marshall starting in the centre on Troy Coates. And also Jarman, he's manned up on Farmer.
Troyan got the tap out that time. One-handed handball, a throw, and it's given against South Belgrave. And the free kick's going to go down there, it looks like, to Matt Sondergel. Hand pass off to Dean Troyan. Kicks the ball quickly into the middle. All South Belgrave there, though. But Doran comes in, lays the tackle. Dean Troyan slides into the ball. Hand pass off to Troy Coates. He kicks it out wide, looking for Farmer. But he's beaten to the ball by South Belgrave. South Belgrave opponent in Cody comes across the pack. Alex Bacon's coming through the middle. His hand pass is cut off by Jason Leeds, the wandered medalist. Down towards Windmar, beaten for it, kicked out wide, out towards the coaches, several coaches box out there, and goes over the boundary line out of bounds for a boundary throw in. 3 minutes gone, first quarter of the grand final. Seville two behind, South Belgrave no score on the Hoogies of Yarra Glen scoreboard.
All right, boundary throw in. What a start. Really intense, the pressure. The boundary throw in, centre wing, the net. Leeds wins it out. Backwards, Brockwell will get there first. Can he get it? He's tackled there by Quilty. Ball well done by Solder. Scooped it up cleanly on his left side. Kicks long in the half forward. Getting back there is Piccoli and also Jarman for South Belgrave. And they see it out of bounds for a boundary throw in about 40 metres out from the Seville goal. Who've done most of the attacking in this game, and they lead two behinds to South Belgrave yet to score on the Hoogies of Yarra Glen scoreboard in this grand final. It'll be Bacons will go up against Troy, and that is Scott at the back. Bacons wins it out towards the boundary line. Punton getting there first, but the boundary line and also CJ Harrison, but the boundary line gets there first, and we'll have another boundary throw in about 50.
Boundary line doesn't move, Jeff.
No, it doesn't.
The ball right. moves, the boundary line doesn't.
All right, boundary throw in at just inside 50 for Seville. In the ruck there, Bacon's done it well there, down there, kick out from Beck, he couldn't get it, Quilty dives on it, was he taken high, no, play on, calls out, spills out to Farmer, he can't get through traffic, also CJ Harrison tries to, and the non-moving boundary line looms up again, and it's another boundary throwing on the forward 50, lot of pressure in there at the moment between both sides, and Seville's half-forward line, this quarter, South Belgrade kicking up towards us in the scoreboard, and it's in several towards the Greyhound end, but the free kick out of the ruck will go to Alex Bacons, who's doing a lot of the ruck work in the back half of South Belgrade in his first 5 minutes of the grand final. He unloads a long one to half forward at the back. Richie Fay couldn't mark it. Dan Isle racing through his Goldsworthy. Could he pick it up? No, he can't. He overrun it. Getting back there was Kane Shaw, but it comes to Goldsworthy. Hooks it round the body to half forward. Sharp out of the lead. Can he get it? He kicks it along further. Paul Marshall picked it up cleanly. Well done from Paul Marshall. That is a fantastic goal for Paul Marshall from half forward. For the first goal of the match in South Belgrave, and boy, Brett Fisher, that was clean. The way he picked it up and just nailed it from about 40 out.
Yep, just a scrubby kick coming in from centre half forward, and the big fella at full forward, Sharp, just came out. It just bounced off his knees, and Marshall swooped one grab and slotted it through from 45.
Yeah, good work that time by Paul Marshall. Geez, he's a class act, isn't he? Yeah, you really need to mark him closely, and he just got a yard on Eddie Wells, and once you give Paul Marshall a yard, he'll take a mile. Andy LaMercia in the middle this time. He's going to throw the ball up in the air. Jason Leeds. Justin Axel jump over the top, but Leeds gets first hand to it. Goldsworthy worked hard, but Kane Shaw grabbed it out of the middle, kicked it long down towards the forward line. Once again, Eddie Wells, he's met heavily, and he'll get a free kick for two high. Eddie Wells with the ball between the centre and the wing. Goes in long, looking down there for Farmer. He goes, no, it's Winmar. He goes out. was in on top of the ball. It's going to be a ball up down on the forward line, you'd say, is it? Oh, no, they very quickly work it out, but Andrew Mercier says, give it to me, boys, and I'll ball it up. Tough, hard work there at the moment. South Belgrave won straight, leading several two behinds on the Hughes Yarra Glen scoreboard. 6.5 minutes gone in the first quarter. Punch back over the boundary line, is it? Oh, it's put the several players pushed over the boundary line there. Hand pass came out from Casey Myers. That's kicked out of there wildly by South Belgrave. Shane Senior leading in the race with the ball. Picks it up, kicks it high, wide and handsome. Looking down there for Farmer. Couldn't take the mark. Down there and kicking the ball out of defence. South Belgrave down towards Richie Fay. Picks it up. Hand passes the ball out wide, picking the ball up and running around the boundary line. Looked like it was Clint Lansbury, and he hits Paul Marshall on half forward. Kicks in long down towards the forward line. Looking down there, but Lee Aitkins comes out, drops the mark. Picking the ball up was Daniel Sharp, who did well. Kicked off the ground by Davies, but it's tapped over the boundary line by Richie Fay for a boundary throw-in.
Brett Fisher, Paul Marshall getting away from Eddie Wells at the moment.
Yeah, I think he's got too much speed for him. He's got a lot of space, and they're providing a lot of space. South Belgrave pushing well out of their 50-metre arc to provide that for him.
The boundary throwing over the back there. It'll come there to... that was to Brock. Well, that was Brock Lansby, sorry. Play continues. We'll have a ball up at half-back for Seville in this first quarter. We've travelled nearly 8 minutes in this first quarter. And the score, Tony, is at the moment 1-0 South Belgrave.
And Seville 2 behinds.
All right, umpire Lee Wallace throws it up at centre-half forward for the Saints. Leads out of the ruck 1-2, but it's not further. Here's Troy Coates getting back. A hand pass off to Lee Aitkins, who's supporting. And a bit of kick will come back to Troy Coates. Taken high after he hand passed it off to Lee Aitkins, and he will take the free kick inside his defensive 50. For Seville in this first quarter, and we've travelled 8.5 minutes in. Troy Coates just looking for options, and we'll head straight out into the middle of the ground. Troy on a long lead, can he mark it? Stumped away by Bacon's pass, Kane Shaw. It'll come to Lansbury, hit Fay at ground level to Brockwell. Salter goes in to Marshall, to Fay. He spins, he'll go back to Rowan Marshall, who lines up, kicks a scrubber into the goal square, but Troy Coates, he overruns it, in they dive. There, it will come to a goal there, fantastic goal there to Bryce Marshall for South Belgrave there, second one from close range, and a good start for the Saints, Brett Fisher.
Yeah, Bryce Marshall, all their on-ballers have been asked, contest the ruck work, push forward. He done that, Bryce Marshall picked up the crumbs and kicked a goal, and I just look for his direct opponent, Troy Coates, and there he is just pushing over through the centre-half back. Centre square line there. So 20 metres off his man. Got to be a lot tighter than that if your opponent's pushing into the forward line as an on-baller.
Back in the middle this time. Andy LaMercier with the ball. South Belgrave, 2 straight 12, leading Seville 2 behinds. And that's on the Hoogies Yarra Glen scoreboard. Kicked in forward this time. Down towards Rowan Marshall. Picked up that time. And kicked out of there by Matt Sondergill. Out wide, and it's going to go down the ground, is it? Or is it going to come back? It's going to go down the ground, and a free kick's going to go to Chris Doran. Doran now looking up forward. Kicks long down there, looking for Mickey Howard. Over the top, Farmer. Couldn't take the mark. Spins out of trouble this time. Gets the ball off. It comes now to CJ Harrison. And CJ puts it through for a goal. Or is it CJ? Yes, it is. CJ Harrison kicks the first goal of the game for Seville. They go on to 1-2-8. Oh, it's a point, is it? Touched off the boot. Well, I thought it was a goal straight away. So that's 3 behinds to Seville. Sorry about that, folks. And CJ Harrison registers a behind. 3 behinds to Seville. Two goals straight to South Belgrave.
All right, I'm on air. I had a few of the gremlins in the line. Apologies, but the kick out, South Belgrave leading this grand final. We've travelled 10 minutes in. It's Quilty who has the mark at half forward. Oh, he goes to go around his man now. It succeeds. Lines up from inside 50. Long kick to the top of the square. Up they fly over the back there. And it's off hands for a point to Seville in this grand final. They go on a 4 behinds on the Hoogies of Yarra Glen scoreboard. Trailing South Belgrave 2 goals straight, and the two Marshalls have the goals for South Belgrave. One
two
to Bryce.
Two
of the three Marshalls. One to Bryce and one to Paul. And Paul Marshall's was a magnificent goal. The kick out will find at half back, and they've got the numbers. It'll come out to Apps, Dustin Apps for South Belgrave, is marked at half back. in this first quarter. Now runs on and unloads a long one. Oh, he's got Punton running for him. Can he mark on the run in the centre? He can. A little in and a half. 40's Bryce Marshall. Oh, picked it up on the half volley. Swings around wide into the pocket, looking out there for that is a Brock Lansbury. He will get it in the pocket. Snap on goal. Just the wrong side of the post for a point to South Belgrave. Their first one on the Hoogies of Yarra Glen scoreboard. That is 2 goals, 1-13 South Belgrave, leading several four behinds. They kick out from full back. Brett Fisher, South Belgrave, probably a little bit more effective up forward.
They are. Their on-ballers are really pushing hard forward. They know they need the extra scoring power, and Seville's on-ballers are just trailing about 15 metres behind them. That inside 50 then was due to the fact that Seville's on-ballers just couldn't stay with them then.
Dean Troyan from full back for Seville kicks a long ball outside of his defence. Leeds at the back, Apps at the front. It comes down. Leeds sockers it off the ground into the path of Eddie Wells. Will he get there first and pick it up? He did well, but he couldn't break the tackle. He loses, but he'll get a free kick in that tackle, and the free kick will go to Eddie Wells right in the centre of the ground for Seville. He will kick it to half. What out and lead is Farmer. Will it reach him? Oh, what a, nearly a great mark. No, it was Windmar, sorry, over the back. Nearly couldn't get it. Well done there, boy. That was by James Beck. Picked it up and headed it out towards Dustin Apps. He fumbled the ball against Leeds. Oh, but he flipped it up beautifully to Bakens. And he comes into half forward. Aikens four. Seville in there first. But well done there by Brock Lansbury. A hand pass on to Goldsworthy through traffic. Breaks it over the top by Hannah Marshall. That is Bryce. He's tackled on to Sharp near the boundary line. Hooked it back, but another point to South Belgrave, which will take them on to 2-2-14, leading several four behinds on the Hoogies of Yarra Glen scoreboard in this first quarter. We've travelled 13 minutes.
Yeah, well, once again, the ball's going to come back to Dean trying to kick out from full back. Looks like South Belgrave just starting to get the ascendancy at the moment on Seville. They started a bit nervously, but they've really picked it up. Jason Leeds in front, punched away from him. Andrew Davies at the bottom of the pack comes through, gets it off to Kane Shaw with a throw, and it's going to be a free kick. Looks like it's going to go to Shane Brockwell in the middle of the ground. It's sent half forward, kicks in. Oh, player on his own out here, and it's Dustin Apps. Gee whiz, you can't leave Dustin Apps on his own because he will hurt you, even though he's got a bit of a funny kicking style, Dustin Apps. He'll kick from about 45 metres, or just about right on the 50 metre line. Just waiting for Dustin Apps. Lining up for his first goal of the game, and South Belgrave's third. 2-2 to four behind so far in favour of South Belgrave. Comes in, it's a very ugly kick off the boot, extremely ugly, goes over and out of bounds on the full. And the free kick's going to go down there to Seville, it's going to go to Dean Troyan. Need to do better with that, Brett, didn't he, Dustin Apps?
Yeah, they've got to put scoreboard pressure on them if they're going to have any chance of breaking the imaginary elastic band.
Dean Troyan goes out long, out towards the wing out there, looking for Tim Bailey. But nobody could take the mark out there. South Belgrave, hand pass over the top to Bryce to Rowan Marshall. He couldn't pick the ball up. Lee Walters is there, ready to say it's a ball up, boys, but it's not, and it's going to be a boundary throw in. Just near the South Belgrave coach's box in front of the hamburger tent over there, and it's going to be thrown back into play once again.
All right, boundary throw in. South Belgrave leads over the back, did it well to Senior, but he ran into Brockwell. Couldn't and will have a ball up there. Couldn't break the tackle, and umpire Lee Wallace has given me fellows. Will have a ball up just outside 50 for South Belgrave in this first quarter. 2-2, they lead several four behinds. Up goes the ball. Leeds against Apps. Leeds, it'll bounce and he'll tap it over the back. But well done by Koski. Fed it out there by Hands. But he'll take a free kick for a high tackle as he got rid of the hand pass there. And we're 9 minutes left in this first quarter. Comes in a Richie Fay at half forward. He's tackled a lot of pressure. Can he get rid of it? Well done by Quilty. Support, but they've got the numbers. Alex Bacon's get back. Round one. Can he get round two? He hand passes out wide looking for Costi, but well done by Quilty. Back to Salter. Salter off the coats. They're under pressure to Dora and all. Pressure there from Alex Bakens. Did well. It'll come to half forward. Paul Marshall, but there'll be a free kick. Will come back. We're throwing the ball. It looks like it might come back to Kane Shaw. Will take the free kick at half back for Seville. Very entertaining grand final. Four shots apiece, but South Belgrave a better accuracy. He goes at the moment to Farmer at half forward. CJ with the crumbs, a little one inboard to Wilson. He'll mark for several, can run on. He's got Winmar breaking at half forward for him. We'll reach him on the bounce. He sits there, looks around the body, looking for Mick Howard getting back, but punt and get back. They drop the mark off his chest, but sockers it through defensively for a point. And another point to Seville. That will take them on to five behinds, trailing South Belgrave on the Hoogers Riviera against scoreboard, 2-14. And a good, they've used the ball wide then, Brett Fisher, coming into their half-forward line, Seville.
Yeah, nothing wrong with that, but they've got to make sure they bring it in extremely quick. They don't want the on-ballers, the South Belgrave on-ballers, pushing deep into the defence and choking up Farmer and Winmar. Got
to get it in quick. Goes out wide, out towards the wing. Mick Howard works hard in there, tries to spoil his man, but it comes through this time. Kick around the corner to Dustin Apps. Apps his tackle. Good tackle that time by CJ Harrison. Gets it off to Jason Leeds. Leeds a pass into the forward line. Well, it's all South Belgrave across there. Tim Bailey comes through, but it's kicked in towards the centre. Troy Coates. Oh, he's met hard by Paul Marshall. Too high, and it's going to be a free kick to Troy Coates in the middle of the ground, and he's not looking well at all, Troy Coates. But he'll get up and take his kick. He's a bit of a tough nut.
See, Paul Marshall hit him hard but fair there. But it was just taken a high with his shoulder. Hit him with his shoulder, but
yeah,
boy.
But he's all right. Troy Coates gets a kick up towards the forward line, looking for Leeds. Leeds up there, couldn't take the mark. Bailey's in there. CJ Harrison couldn't take it. It's quickly got out of there, and South Belgrave through Brockwell, kick it around the corner, and it's marked there by Bryce Marshall. Marshall now kicks the ball into the forward line, looking there for his brother Paul, couldn't take the mark. In there's Daniel Sharp. Eddie Wells taps the ball along in front of himself, kicks the ball off the ground, but Daniel Sharp's in there working hard, picks the ball up, kicks it around the corner. Oh, Paul Marshall stayed when Eddie Wells went, and Paul Marshall's taken the mark 45 metres out on about a 45 degree angle.
Too dangerous. He's very, very dangerous. I'd be making the move now, get Eddie Wells off him and get someone that's going to play a hell of a lot tighter, because he could break this game open in the first 20 minutes.
He's certainly doing that at the moment, Paul Marshall. He'll kick from about 45 metres out. Comes in, just runs inside the 50 and goes bang. Lord's just going to go to the line, is it? Sean Marshall, right on the line, has punched it through for a rush behind to South Belgrave. Sean Wilson, sorry. They go on to 2-3-15 South Belgrave, 7-5 behind.
All right, touched right on the line then from Sean Wilson, Seville. A little one sideways will find Coates will come from Troy, and from the kick out in the back pocket, Troy Coates will get a little one over top to Sean Wilson, reaches him in the half volley. He'll have to go backwards to Coates. He's under pressure, he's tackled, and he's gone.
Yep.
Great tackle there from Daniel Sharp there, and they just perhaps mucked around a little bit too much with him. The kick didn't hit the target, Brett Fisher. And that's
exactly that. You just hit it on the head. Kicks have got to hit their target coming short out of the back half. If you don't, this is the result. He's just inside the boundary, about 35 out, having a shot.
Daniel Sharp for South Belgrave. In he comes. Shot on goal. This looks pretty good. It just might have pushed it the wrong side. I think we'll wait on the umpire. Just a point. Another point to South Belgrave, which will take them on to 2-4. Leading several 5 behinds on the Hoogies of Yarra Glen scoreboard. We've travelled nearly 20 minutes in this grand final. Exciting opening. South Belgrave with just a handy little lead at the moment. It will be Troy, and from full back will kick a long one out. That is Dean right to the centre ground. Paul Marshall, Eddie Wells in towards along the ground to Leeds. He taps it, Leeds back to Wells. He's got support from Sean Wilson by hands running. He goes out wide looking for Mick Howard in the pocket. Will bounce in front of him. Did well around one. Yes, now he can straighten up. Oh, he went back and he's turned around, hooks it back towards the top of the square, but he's missed everything. Out on the full, and perhaps he went one too many then, Mick Howard, I think, and perhaps should have centred it up the first time.
Yeah, the two players standing in the square there, Brett Lawrence Farmer and Mickey Winmar, standing in the square almost on their own.
He went to the left-hand side, should have kicked it with the left, but decided to double back on the right and ended up scrubbing the kick.
The kick out from back in the back top of South Belgrave, thumped away there by Richie Fay at the back, but Sean Wilson over the top looking for Kane Shaw, but Punton did well, used his body, in they dive, Richie Fay, a second effort, but Farmer chops it off, a little soccer one, it'll come back there to Cody, he's tackled there, ball spills out to CJ Harrison, gets a little kick along the line, but here's Alex Bacon's trying to trap it, in they go, is Mick Howard got the ball from a tight angle on his left side, Mick Howard, I think he's nailed it, but a first one for Seville on his left side, Mick Howard, a terrific goal in this grand final, and that will take Seville on to 1-5-11, trailing South Belgrave 2-4-16 on the Hoogers of Yarra Glen scoreboard. Brett Fisher.
Yeah, just an interesting one. Just looking at the matchup, South Belgrave have identified Lee Goldsworthy as their go-to man, and he's obviously matched up on Lee Aitken, and they like that matchup, so they've put him back to the goal square. Good smart stuff by the South Belgrave coaching staff.
Back in the middle with umpire Andy LaMercia. He's going to put it in the air once again this time. Jason Leeds been working hard against Dustin Apps around the ground, but I'd say Apps is just on top at the moment. Leeds gets a tap out, but it goes straight down to Clint Lansbury. Gets a hand pass off. Wayne Deegan kicks it up forward. Rowan Marshall does well and takes a strong mark on his chest in front of Matt Sondergill. Kicks in long, looking for Goldsworthy. Oh, he goes up in front, couldn't take the mark. Kicked around the corner. Daniel Sharp's going to run into the open goal and goes bang. Thank you very much. 3-4-22 to South Belgrave, leading Seville 1-5-11. That's on the Hoogies Yarra Glen scoreboard, 22 and a half minutes gone.
Yeah, it was Shane Brockle that kicked it round the corner and Sharp was alone. And as you said, Tony just ran into an open goal. Too easy, Brett Fisher.
Yep, was too easy. And having said that, the matchup with Goldsworthy and Aitken in the goal square, I think is going to change because Lee Aiken's just being poleaxed. And he's back on his feet now. So, yep, they have identified Goldsworthy as the go-to man. They're going to have to be careful.
Jason Lloyd's got it down again, but once again, that combination, Clint Lansbury and also Wayne Deegan. But Ben Solder breaks from half-back, kicks it long down towards Sean Wilson on the half-forward line. Farmer does well, gets it around the corner near Mick Howard. No, it's Chris Doran down there. Couldn't take the mark, punches it back in. Sean Wilson's working hard on the forward line. So also is Mick Howard, and it's going to be a ball up. Almost on half forward, just on 4 minutes gone in the four minutes to go in the first quarter, and it's deep in Seville's forward 50 at the moment. Lee Walters just waiting to grab the ball back off the players, going to ball it up.
Interesting move there. They've got Richie Fay and Bryce Marshall changing out of the centre at centre half forward,
and Dean Troyan. He's picking up both of those guys at the moment. Tim Bailey, got it down to Chris Doran that time, but it's ripped off the top of the pack. Tim Bailey's gone in there again, but Richie Fay is on the ball now and gets it to Alex Bakins, who kicks the ball around the corner. James Quilty tries to use his pace, but he's muscled off the ball that time. Dustin Apps kicks the ball around the corner. Benny Solder cuts it off with his knees, and it goes down towards Winmar. Oh, bang, crash, and Dustin Apps comes up with the ball, but it's... kicked out of there once again, up to Paul Marshall, couldn't take the mark. He butters up again, Marshall, gets a hand pass out, down to the bottom of the pack, in there and under the pack, and it's hand passed along the line, over the boundary line, out of bounds for a boundary throw in, right in front of the emergency umpires over there, and it'll be thrown back into play. South Belgrave, 3-4-22, leading Seville 1-5-11. On the Hoogers Yarra Glen scoreboard, 25 minutes gone.
Nearing quarter time in this grand final, Division 2 boundary throwing on that outer side in front of the club rooms. About 3 minutes to go in this first quarter. The kick out will come to Clint Lansbury. There, no, it was Coxie into half forward, off hands there. There's a chance for that. Was Brock Lansbury. He's ridden to the ground, but play on calls the umpire. In they dive on it, we'll have a ball up. No, he lets it go. Out the back to Kane Shaw, hurried kick there. Brock Wall on hands and knees, tries to feed it out. But well done by CJ Harrison. He breaks from half back and kicks long to half forward. Farmer come across the front of the pack, couldn't mark. We'd have time to go back and spin around now and straighten out. Look for Winmar on the lead. Is it too foamy? He crunched from behind. Play on calls the umpire. Mick Howard will go for a soccer off the ground into the goal square, but well done by South Belgrave. That was Jarman defending across the line. We'll kick it out wide, but Wilson will get there first for Seville, but he's got two players against him. That is Punton will go over the top by hands to Richie Fay. Kicks mid-air. Play on calls the umpire. Lawrence Farmer goes in again. He couldn't get it. Doran's in there. They dive on each other and we'll have a ball up at half forward for Seville. 26 minutes in this first quarter, and it's pretty heated in there.
Bad matchup.
This is red hot at the moment, Brett.
Bad matchup just here, boys. Wayne Deegan on CJ Harrison. He comes forward. Not going to be good looks for the Seville.
Alex Bacon's out of the ruck, but Lawrence Farmer tries to break the tackle of Cody there, and he's pushed out of bounds for a throw-in, says the umpire. Fair tackle, and then we'll have a boundary thrown at half forward. We've travelled nearly 26 minutes in this first quarter, and South Belgrave hold a slender lead in this first quarter. They lead 3-4 to 1-5 in this grand final. From Bacons, who's been a good player down back, kicks to centre in. Brockwell did trap it well, will spin around on his right side. He better hurry up, just got a little. It'll come to Brock Lansbury. He's tackled off the ball and he's gone. Great tackle from Kane Shaw. He'll be rewarded for his tackle, and Kane Shaw will take the kick at centre wing for Seville. He's got Troyan running past by hands. That is Dean. He goes into half forward. Alex Bacons did well. Shane Senior goes in. It'll spill back to Bacons. He knocks it out. Tim Bailey will get up first. The big fella picked it up. Crunched into Lansbury. Come to Richie Faye right near the boundary line. He sees it out of bounds for a boundary throw in on centre wing on this scoreboard side of the ground.
Boundary throw in. Just about quarter time now, just under a minute to go. Throw in this time on the wing. Bailey up against Bacons. Tapped down by Tim Bailey. They're down to the bottom of the pack. In there working hard was Kane Shaw. Gets a little toe poke to it. Oh, it's tough and hard in there at the moment. Kicked up, Jason Leeds takes the mark at centre half at half forward. Needs to get it on quickly. Down towards the forward line. Goes long to the top of the square. Oh, this is a goal! Straight through for Jason Leeds from 55 metres out. What an absolute beauty by Jason Leeds. 2-5-17 to Seville. 3-4-22 to South Belgrave. That's on the Hoogies Yarra Glen scoreboard.
Well, Brett Fisher, you think that Seville nearing quarter time would be reasonably happy with that scoreline, because you think South Belgrave have had much of their play in this first quarter.
Oh, they've squandered probably three of their five opportunities, or four behinds that they've kicked. They've squandered probably three of those, and very smart stuff by Big Leedsy, seeing the open goal square, knew that the ball, once it hits the deck, is going to skid straight, just had to get it online.
Jason Leeds taps the ball out wide. In there's Clint Lansbury trying to pick the ball up again, in and under the pack. Lansbury working hard in there with James Quilty. Comes out towards Deegan, goes out towards the top of the square. No one can pick the ball up, and it's going to be a free kick. It's going to be a yellow card, I think, against Wayne Deegan for an elbow in the head of CJ Harrison. And yes, it is a yellow card to Wayne Deegan. He's going to go from the ground, and it's going to be CJ Harrison to take the kick, and it'll be 50 as well.
Gee, that could be costly, because now Deegan will be missing for virtually 15 minutes in that second quarter, won't he?
And 50 metres as well will take CJ Harrison to almost the 10-yard square, and he will kick for goal, and this will just give Selwell the lead by a point at quarter time. Yeah,
3 seconds to go quarter, boys. He's going to kick in the last 20 seconds.
Yeah, he's going to kick from about 25 out the mark, the man on the mark.
CJ Harrison with the advantage of a 50-metre penalty comes in, kicks truly, and as the siren goes for quarter time, Selwell have the lead by a point.
Just about ready for a start in this Division 2 Grand Final with Seville.
Just waiting for a few supporters to leave the ground over there. Unfortunately, we've lost our boundary rider today, but being a trainer for Yarra Junction, Pete Dell's elsewhere.
He's celebrating now. We'll let him off. All right, we're just about ready. A big crowd building up here at the Hillsville Sporting Complex for the start, and we're away in the second quarter. With umpire Lee Waddles throws it up in the middle. Apps will go up against it, but Leeds wins it down. Brockwell, was he held? He tried to go through for South Belgrave, and Senior dives on it and is tied up for another ball up right in the middle of the ground with umpire Lee Waddles. And Seville, this quarter, will be coming down towards us in the scoreboard end, and South Belgrave up towards the Greyhound Complex end in this ground. Knocked out of the ruck. It'll come there to Koski. Koski for South Belgrave. Gets it up further, and a good mark and lead to Richie Fay. Took a good mark at half forward. Long way out here. We'll centre it up across the ground to half forward. Looking in the back there for Brock Lansbury. He couldn't get it. Marshall's pulled off the ball. That was Bryce. In they go hard, and we'll have another ball up at centre half forward. We've travelled 40 seconds in this second quarter.
I've picked up a change, Brett Fisher, that Ben Salter's gone to Paul Marshall now.
Yeah, oh look, they've obviously told Ben, you've got to shut this guy down, because if you don't, then you're going to keep their South Valgrave chances alive.
Clint Lansby tries to break out of the pack, but there's a free kick off the ball for a high tackle. It will go to Troy, and that is Dean. Kicks from half back out wide. He's got Sondergaard running. Will it bounce in front of him? Will it sit for him? Yes, it does. He's hotly being hooks it back across half forward. Over the top, punting, getting back first for South Belgrade. Did well, but good tackle there from Wilson. And they go hard. Well done there by Quilty. Hand pass off there, looking for Lee Aikens, and they dive on the ball. It's now just inside 50 for Seville. Coming down towards the scoreboard in this second quarter of the Division 2 Grand Final. The Oryx Australia scoreboard, Seville lead by a point, 23-22. Bailey in the ruck, taps it down to Senior. He couldn't break clear, but Alex Bacon's gets it and kicks it in the middle of the ground. Here he comes as Lee Aikens is knocked off the ball. Also in there might have been Salter. He's tied up and will have a ball up right in the middle of the ground for umpire Lee Walters.
Yeah, Lee Walters with the ball now. Right in the middle, in a little bit of a glue pot there in the centre of the ground. Goes up, Bacon's comes over the top and taps it down. Kane Shaw picks it up and handballs it out wide looking for Quilty. Didn't sit for him that time. Rowan Marshall working hard in there. Brockwell's off the side of the pack looking for the ball, but it's going to be a high tackle, and it's going to go to Rowan Marshall out there on the wing. Wing on the clubroom side of the ground, goes in long towards half forward, up there. Punched away that time by Troy and goes down to the front of the pack. CJ Harrison slung, but it went straight up and straight down. Goes to the bottom of the pack, and umpire Andrew LaMercia says, give it to me, boys, and I'll ball it up. Deep in the forward line for South Belgrave. Just looking at the moment to rest back the lead. Ben Salter gets a hand pass out. Goes to Dean Troyan. He's pulled off his kick. CJ Harrison goes in there hard, working hard in there, but it's going to be a free kick to CJ Harrison in the back pocket. It's going to be CJ Harrison will get the free kick.
He's working hard, isn't he, CJ?
He's working extremely hard at the moment, CJ Harrison in the back pocket. Kicks out wide, out towards the half back line. Coming away with it is Shane Brockwell for South Belgrave, though. Kicks it into half forward, and in there is Brock Lansbury, who takes the mark on half forward. Kicks it in long. Up there, Andrew Davies. Oh, strong work in there as well. That's not good at all. And it's going to be 50 metres against Bryce Marshall. And it's going to go all the way down to half forward. And Andrew Davies will take the kick. Very, very undisciplined that time by Bryce Marshall. Trying extremely hard at the moment, South Belgrave, to get back in the contest, but they're using their aggression in the wrong way, Brett.
Yes, mate, they are. They're going to cost themselves two goals here.
Andrew Davies kicks in long, looking for Winmar. Ducks back, takes the mark, 20 metres out on about a 50-degree angle. And Nicky Winmar will have a shot for goal. Let's see if his kicking's a bit better than it was last week at Powtown, where he kicked three goals. Six or seven or eight, I think it was, Jeff, for the game. Comes in, Winmar, off two paces. Goal, umpire, does not move. Goal to Nicky Winmar. Goal to Seville. They go 7 points in front, Seville now. 4-5, 29 to Seville. 3-4, 22 to South Belgrave. Brett?
Yep, look, two indiscretions, two goals, and more than a goal and a half in front now. So, they just cannot do it. They've got to get the runner out there and tell these guys, settle yourselves down, because at the end of the day, you're going to cost them a premiership.
Exactly right, Brett Fisher, and I like the way that Winmar just bodied Beck there for South Bowery. James Beck in
that
marking contest.
He
certainly has. We're back in the middle. Apps will go against Leeds. They nullify, but CJ, it's kicked off the side a bit. Half forward Farmer works off his opponent, breaks one tackle, yes, hand pass. Now he backs around, just gets a hurry kick. It'll come to Mick Howard. Oh, got it out quickly to Quilty. But a throw, according to the umpire, against Mick Howard, and the free kick will come back to Jarman for South Belgrave in his defensive 50 defending. He will go straight up the line in the middle. He's got Dustin Apps against, works off beautifully off Leeds and marks and runs on Dustin Apps. He's got Sharp out in the lead, but Davies getting back. Terrific mark. Fantastic mark to Andrew Davies, and he's been a fantastic player this year for Seville, that fullback. And what a great mark. He will go across the ground looking for Kane Shaw at the back, and it's overhead. It'll come to block Brock Lansby at the back of the pack, over the top to Paul Marshall. He goes in forward over the back there, but getting back there, guess who? Again, Andrew Davies taking his second mark with inside 30 seconds, defending in the back pocket for Seville. He kicks in the man of the mark, but it'll come over the top to Solder, play on to call it half back. Turns around for Seville. He's got Quilty too far for him. He runs on. Here's Farmer and Apps. They go in. Oh, crunch. They hit each other. And oh boy, what a clash of bodies then. Is it James Quilty, I think, that's injured? He copped a big one from Dustin Apps in the contest. And he's a pretty sore James Quilty. And we'll have a ball up on that outer side. And play continues there. Tim Bailey in the ruck. Knocked out from Bacons to Clint Lansbury. Quick hands there on to Brockwell. Over top to Apps running through the middle. The big ruckman kicks a long ball into the forward line. Daniel Sharp crunch. Ball hits the ground. Here's Goldsworthy. Couldn't pick it up for South Belgrave. Under a lot of pressure there. Seville tied up. We'll have a ball up at half forward for South Belgrave, and we've travelled 7 minutes in this second quarter.
Looks like Eddie Wells has gone to Lee Goldsworthy as well. Brett Fisher down in the forward line.
Yep, they've changed him over.
Tapped out that time. Down on the bottom of the pack. Tim Bailey got the tap out that time, but Lee Wilder says it's going to be another ball up.
James Quilty off, Stewie Boyce on in that. We got injured in that, so we'll just have to see how he is. But Quilty off and Stewie Boyce on.
Yep, thanks very much, Jeff. Tapped out of the bottom of the pack. Hand pass out. Oh, tough and hard in there. Ben Solder picks the ball up. Gets a hand pass out. Punched away again. Down in the forward line for South Belgrave. Richie Fay kick up forward. But Lee Aiken stands there and takes a strong mark in defence for Seville. He's going to go out wide to Andrew Davies, who's all alone out here. He's got space to move at the moment. He's going to kick in towards Shane Senior. It's a shocking kick off the boot. Chris Koski, hand pass off to Goldsworthy. Goldsworthy runs inside 50.
Oh,
I think it's a goal. Great goal to Lee Goldsworthy. Ran inside 50 and kicked the goal. And they're back within a point, South Belgrave. They go on to 4-4-28, trailing Seville 4-5-29. And that is on the Orange Australia second quarter scoreboard, 8 minutes gone.
And Brett Fisher, a poor kick from Andrew Davies in, caused the turnover and they paid for it.
Yeah, well, that's what they've got to do. You've got to make the most of your opportunities, and Lee Goldsworthy did. They've identified him. They're going to channel the ball through him. So Seville needs to pick up on that and ensure that they chop everything off that gets hit the supply through to him.
Tim Bailey into the ruck and Jason Lloyd's into the forward line. Bailey running out of the ruck. Hand pass off to CJ Harris. Another hand pass on to Kane Shaw. Kicks it into Stewie Boyce. Runs on the experienced player for Seville. Hand pass over the top looking for Mick Howard. He's hit high. No free kick. Stewie Boyce is in there under the pack, battling hard under there as he always does, the little ferret. And it's going to be a ball up by Andrew LaMercia.
Right, ball up at half forward for Seville. We've travelled 9 minutes in this second quarter. Over the top, well done by Alex Bacons. He goes backwards to Shane Brockwell by hand. Kicks out to that outer side, right on centre wing, in front of the club rooms at Hillsville. It's out of bounds, right in front of the umpires there. The interchange bench for the umpires.
Ivan Walters, the emergency umpire.
Yes, and we'll have a boundary throw in there in this grand final. Apps works his opponent, Bailey, off. Feeds out there. Kane Shaw did well there in the contest to tie it up, and we'll have a ball up at centre wing on that outer side, and a big crowd has built up.
But that's interesting, putting Tim Bailey in the ruck instead of Dean Troy.
Yeah, well, they obviously need Dean to stick at centre half back on Richie Fay. Leedsy now is at centre half forward, Bailey in the ruck. Leedsy, I'd be pushing out there. He's really choking up space. I'd move Doran out and allow Winmar to go one out.
Shane Senior on to Lee Aikens. He goes in forward to Jason Leeds at his feet. Can he feed? Broke the tackle and straightened up for goal. Jason Leeds shot on goal. Straight through the middle. What a goal from their coach of Seville. Jason Leeds just with sprint. Brett Bishop.
Yep.
A turn off his opponent, broke the tackles, turned around, straightened up, went bang, straight through.
He actually used the pace of his opponent that was chasing him. He knew that he was going to have to stop. He kept his feet, stopped, used the pace of his opponent that was chasing just to brush him off. He couldn't keep going because of the slippery ground. Just turned around and just had a two-step shot at goal and slotted it through.
Seville 5-5-35 lead South Belgrade 4-4-28 on the Oryx Australia scoreboard. We've travelled 10 and a half minutes in this grand final in the second quarter. Bailey against Apps. No one, they nullify each other. But Bailey goes on hands and knees out to Shaw as he pushed off it. It'll come there to Salter. He loses the ball. Wilson tackles in there. It was Troy Coates actually. And we'll have a ball up just wide of the centre on that, favouring the outer side in this Division 2 grand final. What a great goal for Jason Leeds, the Jim Wandon medal in Division, best and fairest Division 2 this year, Jim Wandon medalist. Away we go again, a big pack of Bailey out to Coates. Oh, good inside handball to CJ Harrison, running, goes long, backing back his boys. Can he mark it? No, he couldn't. It'll come to Winmar. He will swing around his left side, hooks a little one round the corner to Boyce again. He will go backwards to Winmar by hands. He's around punting now. He'll straighten up a little one inboard to Troy Coates. He's marked inside 50. Really good play from Seville there, the build up, and Troy Coates has marked, but he will kick right on 50 for the Seville Football Club.
A little bit too far out from Troy Coates to score for me, you'd say, Brett Fisher.
Definitely, he's looking for the pass.
Kicks in high to the top of the square. Leeds is in there. Farmer! Over the top. Lawrence Farmer's taken the mark. What an absolute ripper. Right on the point of the goal square almost, and Farmer will have a shot for goal from about 10 metres out the on a 45 degree angle.
What a magnificent mark.
Great mark. Troy Coates, fantastic, good thinking. That's knowing your teammates. He knew that he had to get it in there and they had the marking power and he goes through as slow as a goal.
Lawrence Farmer kicks his first goal of the game. That'll give him some confidence, Lawrence Farmer. Three goals to Seville in the quarter. They go on to 6-5-41. Leading South Belgrade 4-4-28. That's on the Orange Australia second quarter scoreboard. We've gone 12 and a half minutes.
Just a classic case. I'm just looking at the Seville forward line and the years and the experience that's amongst them with Stewie Boyce and Nicky Winmar and Jason Leeds and Mick Howard. Geez, there's probably 200 years of bloody football there.
You're not wrong.
And they're using all the experience, the smarts. Get the ball up to us, boys, and we'll get the goals for you.
Andy LaMercia back in the middle. Timmy Bailey taps it out. Troy Coates working hard in there at the bottom of the pack. It's going to be another ball up. Andrew Mercier says, give it to me, boys, just as Clint Lansby was about to break away with it. Lemercia back in the middle. Throws it up this time. Bailey up against Rowan Marshall, it looks like, in the middle now. Up there in the top. Coming through. Tap down, Kane Shaw brings it out wide. Leeds up against Bacon's. Bacon's playing in front, comes through, kicks, taps down, and Lawrence Farmer smothered it off the boot. Pick tries to pick it up, couldn't do so. Cody goes around the boundary line with a kick, down towards the bottom of the pack, coming through that time. Oh, great tackle. That's Richie Faye, picks the ball up, heads for the boundary line, just inside the line, goes over and out for a boundary throw in. We've gone 13 minutes and 35 seconds in the second quarter of the grand final. Seville 6-5-41, leading South Belgrade 4-4-28. Absolute cracking game here on the Oryx Australia scoreboard at the boundary throw-in. Out on the wing, on the attacking side of the ground, tapped down to the front, Dean Troyan, hand pass out, comes out to Troy Coates, tries to work his way through. Troyan with strength gets it on to Senior. Senior on to Sondergel. Sondergel back to Troy Coates. They're under pressure, Seville. Troy Coates does well, gets it out to Troyan. Troyan tries to spin around, get it across. Ben Solder back towards the Andrew Davies. Couldn't pick the ball up. Back down to the bottom of the pack, in it under the pack, and it's gone, and it's going to be holding the ball there, and it's going to go to South Belgrade.
Paul Marshall with a free kick against Bailey there. Marshall quickly on, will kick it long into his forward zone. Deegan back on the ground, backing out, it's taking the mark, but against him, pushing his opponent in the back, and the free kick will go to Seville down back there against Wayne Deegan. Will go to CJ Harrison there. He hand passes it off to Troy and goes wide out to that outside, but a good mark to Brock Lansbury in front of his opponent for South Belgrade now. So they need a goal, the Saints. He'll go a little one into half forward, looking for Sharp on the lead. Thumped away by Sean Wilson for Seville at the back. Apps is there first and he hooks around, but his kick smothered. Well done by Sean Wilson. Did well there to tie it up and cause a ball up. Very good work from Sean Wilson from Seville Football Club. We have a ball up at half forward for
the smother there was by Ben Solder, and I reckon he's dislocated a finger, Ben Solder, but geez, he did well there off the boot of Dustin Apps.
All right, in the ruck, Apps and Troyan knocks it out. That is knocked out by Dean Troyan further on towards the wing, towards Boyce. Will he get there first against Rowan Marshall? Did well, Stewie Boyce. Oh, fed it out to Coates. Hand pass will come over the top there. Oh, looking for Eddie Wells. He's under a lot of pressure, and it's forced out of bounds.
It's
coming back for a free kick against. We'll come back to South Belgrave, and it will go back to Punton. Andrew Punton will take the free kick at half back or centre wing, right in front of the social club at the Healesville Sporting Complex. He's off and running in this second quarter across the ground. Oh, Farmer will chop this off. Poor disposal from Punton, and Lawrence Farmer has marked about 60 out quickly on to Winmar out in the lead, backing back. Well done by Beck. Thumps away. He's Mick Howard at ground level. Did well, fed it out to Winmar, but he's tackled. Play on. It's called the umpire, and he's been pinged according to the umpire, and it's against Nicky Winmar, and a free kick will come. And oh, there's 50 metres. No, Nicky, not to do, and it's 50 metres there, and against Nicky Winmar for throwing a ball away, and shouldn't have done it, Brett Fisher.
No. Look, inside 50, they've got momentum. The ball came in, and just because he completed the contest, you just can't do that. He's got the experience to know. Just let it go, Nicky, and get on with the game.
Chris Koski kicks the ball in towards half forward. Tim Bailey almost scooped it up that time. Brock Lansbury kicks the ball in. Down around the forward line once again. Troyan goes off the ground. Did it well that time. Dean Troyan headed for the boundary line. Knocked it out of bounds, and it'll be a boundary throw in on half forward. Inside the 50 once again for South Belgrave. Seville 6-5-41 leading South Belgrave 4-4-28. Deep in the second quarter on the Orange Australia scoreboard. They're down to the bottom of the pack again. Davies kicked the ball out of there. But it's right on the 50 metre line. It's going to be a free kick to Seville, and it's going to go to, looks like Tim Bailey there, is it? Yes, it is. Bailey right on the 50 metre line in the defensive half of his ground. Kicks in long, down towards the wing, looking in there for Jason Leeds, up against Alex Bakens. Andrew Punton at the bottom of the pack, hand passes the ball out. Leeds is in there working hard. Punton goes back in after the ball. Leeds taps it out. Rowan Marshall leading in the race with the ball, picks it up now, kicks the ball around the corner. It goes up high. Up there's Kane Shaw, couldn't take the mark, and it's gone off him and over the boundary line, out of bounds for a boundary throw in. Just near the Seville coach's box, in between there and half forward. On the South Belgrave forward side of the ground, as comes through now, and Kane Shaw goes through with a head of steam, but it comes out this time to Bryce Marshall, smothered off the boot once again. Good work by Seville. Hand pass comes out, goes to CJ Harrison. His kick smothered off the boot and over the boundary line, out of bounds for a boundary throw in. Yeah. Heaps of 1%ers out there, Brett.
Yeah, great. Oh, look, CJ just needed to get that handball through to Boyce, and he was away, and inside 50 they go again.
Tim Bailey taps the ball down, goes down to the bottom of the pack. And there's, looks like Clint Lansbury getting the kick up forward.
A half forward, but it's tied up by Deegan there. It's just pushing up towards half forward on that outer side. We've travelled 18 and a half minutes in this grand final. And Seville 6-5-41 lead South Belgrave 4-4-28. The throw up there for knocked out by Rowan Marshall. There's also going through there was Casey Myers, but he's tied up. We'll have another ball up. Virtually pushing up towards half forward for South Belgrave.
Kane Shaw again laying another great tackle in there.
He's tough in there, isn't he, Kane Shaw? Nugget, as they call him. Over the back, the free kick in the infringement in the ruck contest. It will go to Wayne Deegan, back on the ground from the sin bin for shepherding, and he will take the free kick at centre wing. Wayne Deegan, he will unload a long torpedo, and he's got onto it right to the forward. Up they fly over the back at ground level. Can they get it? But well done by Lee Aiken, socket it off the ground, out of bounds for a boundary throw in about 40 metres around from the South Belgrave goal. And that was a long kick from Wayne Deegan, wasn't he? Unloaded the big torp in this grand final. They need a goal, the Saints, before half time. There's the throw in over the top. Well done by Richie Fay, but he lost the ball. It's tied up there. Big pack of players. And umpire Lee Walder says, give it to me, fellas. We'll have another ball up at half forward for the Saints. We've travelled nearly 20 minutes in this second quarter of the Division 2 grand final for this year. about 4 minutes left in the quarter. There's a hand pass will come out from Seville. Will come out the sharp. The Sharp, well done there by Troy Coates. He lost the ball, but well done by Daniel Sharp. He made a second effort. Hooks at the top. He's Marshall. Oh. Rowan, what a fantastic mark. Beautiful mark at centre half forward for Rowan Marshall. He's just waiting now. He nearly went. No, he's just waiting for a crowded full line now. He was going to decide. He'll go out to the pocket. On a lead is Deegan. Backing back. Well, there's a good mark over the back there to Brock Lansbury. What a fantastic mark there over the back of the pack. And he's marked in the forward pocket for South Belgrave. He would be about 25 out on a 60 degree angle. And as I said, they need a goal before half time. In he comes, Brock Lansbury, a low kick. Has he swung it enough in? I don't think he has, but he's one behind. And another point to South Belgrave will take them on to
4-5-29, Jeff. Trailing Seville, 6-5-41. Brett?
Yeah, Richie Fay's been taken from centre half forward, so they're starting to get a little bit of the jitters up South Belgrave. And, key player, key playmaker.
Kick out from fullback by Dean Troy. Oh, that was pretty silly. Also by Chris Koski. But Shane Senior bounces up, kicks up towards half forward, looking for Troy Coates. Jason Leeds working hard in there. So too also as Troy Coates. And also hand pass over the top from Rowan Marshall. Comes out towards Cody. He's tackled with the ball. Lansbury kicks it up forward in towards Kane Shaw, who takes the mark on half back for Seville. Just working hard at the moment, Seville just keeping South Belgrave out at the moment. 21 and a half minutes gone in the second quarter of the Division 2 Grand Final. Farmers up, couldn't take the mark. Cody dances in on top of the ball, and he's wrapped up in there by Tim Bailey, and it's going to be a ball up. Once again, Lee Walters. Had very, very good control of the game so far, the umpires doing extremely well. Bailey got the tap out. Koski kicks it up forward towards the half, the point of the square. Marshall's beaten for it. Troyan does well with strength. Breaks away and kicks long towards the half forward line, looking for Chris Doran out there. Doran runs onto it with Casey Myers. Well, this will test his hamstring out, Chris Doran. But he goes through and it goes over the band line out of bounds for a boundary throw in.
Not the one you wanted, a 50-yard sprint to test your hammy out in the grand final, for who was it?
Not really. Bailey and also his opponent there in Luke O'Neill, go rushing for the ball. Getting in and under the pack there is Seville. They couldn't clear it out of there. Bailey tackles his opponent that time. Getting a hand pass out. Oh, well done that time by Kane Shaw again. Taps it through over the band line out of bounds right in front of the social club.
Very dangerous here. Seville win the footy. We've got Troy Coates on his own here. They're one man short, South Belgrave. Just push them back one now.
Boundary throw in on the half forward line. 23 minutes gone in this second quarter. Oh, the South Belgrave player ran into Lee Walters and bounced off him. Shane Senior came through, but it's going to be a free kick to Seville, is it? Is it going to go the other way?
South Belgrave
it's going to, and for a high tackle. And I think it was Troy Coates there who accidentally ran into a player, and he's gone down, and it's going to be a free kick to South Belgrave. Looks like it's Shane Brockwell who's gone down, but Lee Goldsworthy will take the kick.
Lee Goldsworthy with Brockwell not well in the hands of the Trojans, going straight off the ground, I think.
And Griffiths will come on.
Yes, he will. And it might be Koski. Yes, we'll wait and see on that. Keep your eye on that one,
Phil. It is Koski, yes.
Yeah, now Lee Goldsworthy with a free kick at half back, kicks a long, beautiful kick into the centre ground. Leeds getting back, can't mark off hands. In they go there. Doug Griffith did well on the ground, fresh at ground level, gets it, but well done by Jason Lee. Back down the back, hooks at the half forward. Here's Nicky Winmar, but well done by Cody. He met the ball in the front and got it. Thumped away by Troy in the middle of the ground. In they go hard. Oh, the pressure's on there. They go crunch, but it'll come out sideways towards Eddie Wells. Can he run it down? He did. On centre wing, he will line up and kick it long, looking for Winmar.
Oh,
right
beautiful.
Near the boundary line, taking it right in front of the coach's box there for Nicky Winmar. What a great mark. Just inside the line there. You would have to think that he may be too far up, but you never know.
Beautiful kick by Eddie Wells, wasn't it?
Was it? Great speed. Did you see him pull away?
He's always been pretty pacey, Eddie Wells, ever since I used to play cricket with him.
Nicky Winmar lines up, long shot at goal, but I think it might just scrape. Now it's out on the full. He was a long way out. It's out in the full in the forward pocket, and the free kick will go to Alex Bacon's in the back pocket. We're nearly 25 minutes in this second quarter grand final. 6-5-41, Seville lead South Belgrave 4-5-29. waiting for the ball to come back into play. And Brett Fisher, just Seville, just with a handy little lead, 12 points.
They're just starting to step the pace up, and you know, you can see a few cracks just starting to form in the South Belgrave armour, and to their credit, they're sticking with it. But yeah, the ante is starting to rise.
Alex Bakens kicks it out wide. Jason Leeds couldn't take the mark. In and under the pack was Doug Griffiths. Seville Watt once again working hard in the packs. Kane Shaw comes out, gets it out to CJ Harrison, kicks it in, and Stewie Boyce running like a spring chicken, takes the mark at half forward, kicks in long, in towards the forward line, looking for Leeds. Doran's going to come from the back, but Alex Bakens takes a strong mark in defence. Hand pass off on there too, looks like Lee Goldsworthy. Down to the bottom of the pack, punched away though, comes to Sean Wilson, on to Shane Senior, just before the siren, go to Shane Senior, right on the siren for half time. Just before the siren went, Shane Senior kicks his first and the fourth for the quarter to Seville, and they go into half time. 7 goals, 5:47. Seville 4:5:29 to South Belgrave. Great work that time by Shane Senior.
It might be Doran, Chris Doran is one of them. And
I can't see Scott Troy in the other one.
I can't see Quilty at all on the ground, so he copped a heavy knock, and maybe he might be coming back, which is a shame because he's a real class act, James Quilty. But as I mentioned, Stewie Boyce at half forward and immediate impact.
Yeah, he did. And also, having Lenny Melchior on there also as a small forward, there's another experienced player to chuck in the forward line as well. So. And standing in the goal square, Nicky Winmar and Mickey Howard, and also the six players across half forward.
Also, we see Craig Kazina on the ground here on centre wing on Shane Senior. Craig Kazina for South Belgrave. We're just about ready for a start in this second half, the last half of the year for these two teams. It's all up for grabs, the grand final, the premiership. And boy, Seville with a handy lead at this stage. They lead 8-5-53 to South Belgrave 4-5-29 in the third quarter that we brought for you by ESP Tech Force in this third quarter.
Andy LaMercier to start us off, to start the final quarter. Rolls the ball up and we're underway in the second half of this Division 2 Grand Final. Jason Leeds up in the ruck against Dustin Apps. Leeds got first hand of the ball that time. Down to the bottom of the pack, Troy Coates in there battling hard for it, and Andy LaMercier is going to have to ball it up again. Brent?
Yes, Alex Bakens has been moved to full forward. There is changes. Marshall has not gone into the midfield. Deegan has stayed in there. He's ruck roving. His direct opponent is CJ Harrison.
Up in the ruck, Leeds got first hand of the ball. Down to the bottom of the pack once again. Little flip out. CJ Harrison picks it up. Kicks it up. Lenny Melchior fighting for the ball in there. Farmer picked it up like it was a dry ball. Kicks it in towards the forward line. Nicky Winmar comes out with pace. Picks the ball up. No, he doesn't. Kicked off the ground that time by his opponent. And over towards the band line, out of bounds. Looks like Daniel Sharp's gone back on Nicky Winmar.
So they've rung the changes, Brett Fisher?
Yep, they have. They've pretty much reshuffled the deck chairs, like we said. Bakens has gone from centre-half back to full forward. And what was that guy's name you just
Daniel
picked
Sharp.
Up there? Daniel Sharp's
Daniel
gone
Sharp.
From full forward to full back.
Comes out this time, kicked off the ground by South Belgrave, by Goldsworthy, out towards Jason Leeds. He's going to get a free kick for kicking in danger, and it's going to go to the Jim Wandon medalist for 2003, Jason Leeds, the coach of Seville on the wing. Kicks in long, down towards the half forward line, looking for Farmer, and Farmer doesn't let him down and takes the mark on the burst. Goes in long, down towards the top of the square. Winmar comes out, couldn't take the mark, dragged to the ground, no free kick, down the bottom of the pack. Winmar goes in hard, picks the Mick Howard picks the ball up, spins it round the corner for a goal to settle. They start the third quarter with the first goal to Mick Howard. They go on to 9 goals, 5:59 to South Belgrave 4:5:29. Brett Fisher.
Yep, great goal. Another smart Crumming forwards goal. Farmer, great lead out onto the wing. He's pushed from the forward pocket, took a great diving chest mark on the wing, gets it in long and strong. Two out, Nicky Winmar. Howard's opponent actually left him to go and help his opponent on Winmar, and which left Mickey Howard free. Picks it up, crumbs across the body and goal.
All right, great start to Seville in this second half of the grand final. They're away to a very, very handy lead. Back in the middle, leads, but Apsel wins it down. In goes Casino Hart. He couldn't get the ball, but well done by Kane Shaw. Boys tough, but Deegan did well. Fed a hand pass to Brockwell onto Lansbury, but he couldn't get it. Sondergaal kicks it off the ground. Oh, in they go hard. Sondergaal again with a second effort. Dives on it half forward and over ball up. Interesting to note, when Farmer kicked it in long to Winmar on the lead, Mickey Howard screened his... just so Winmar could lead. Very experienced stuff there, and it ended up with a goal to McHowd, his second for the game.
A little bit of work on Nicky Winmar down on the forward line. He might have just slightly injured his knee in that contest.
Leads out of the ruck from half back, comes out there. We'll have another ball up there. It's tied up just outside the 50 for South Belgrave in this third quarter, in the grand final, Division 2. There's the ball up there. It'll be Leeds against Apps as they've gone all day. This time Leeds wins it out at the back. No one can break out there. Great tackle there by Sean Wilson for Seville. Ties it up again. We'll have another ball up. No, free kicker. We'll go to Brock Lansbury there.
Just pushed him in the back of the head then, and Brock Lansbury with a free kick.
Rick Leon in the half forward. Rowan Marshall, but Troy at the back sprawls it. Well done by Sondergaal. We leaves a high ball back to outside 50. Sitting under, it's Lee Aikens. Took a good mark there. Outside his defensive 50. Quickly on out there to Farmer on a good lead. He's threatening to open up this. He started the third quarter beautifully. Lawrence Farmer, he turns around, kicks a long one. He's got Stewie Boyce running back alone. Marks runs on from 30 out on a tight angle as he put it through. Stewie Boyce, he goes for another one for Seville. They go on to on the ESP Tech Force scoreboard. Seville
10 goals, 5-65 to Seville, 4-5-29 to South Belgrave.
Yep, great smart stuff. Geez, the pace of Lawrence Farmer. They're looking for him, and he is actually attracting two or three opponents every time him or Nicky Winmar goes near the balls, which actually makes it so much easier for Boyce and Howard. Boyce, he let his opponent go and doubled back, found himself 30 metres free, and Lawrence Farmer spotted him. That's all he had to do when he slotted it.
Ball up in the middle once again. Jason Lloyd's getting on top of Dustin Apps in the middle now. Down at the bottom of the pack, Deegan's in there working out for South Belgrave. It comes out, Lansbury kicks it round the corner up towards half forward. South Belgrave pushing the ball into attack. Sondergaal does well. Casina, first possession, hand pass to Rowan Marshall. Marshall from just inside the 50 metres. Bacon's up forward, couldn't take the mark. Griffiths gets a hand pass back out. In there to Goldsworthy. Ducks around, 1-2 on the line. Davies rushes the behind to South Belgrave. They go on to 4-6-30. Trailing Seville 10-5-65 in the Division 2 Grand Final. And Dean trying to kick out from fullback again.
Yeah, good, smart, strong stuff. Andrew Davies, that's what he's known for. Renowned for just staying there on the line and getting a touch on it.
Troyan plays on from fullback, kicks out wide. Out there looking for Troy Coates. Will he get it before the boundary line? No, he doesn't. Goes over the line, out of bounds for a boundary throw-in. He's played on from fullback, doing Troyan. It can't be a free kick for out of bounds on the full. It's a boundary throw-in. As we saw last week.
Yeah, good decision from umpire. Walder's right on the ball.
Yep, yeah, he saw that Dean Troyan played on. Bailey in the ruck up against O'Neill. Goes to the bottom of the pack, Bailey. Looking for Senior. In there's Deegan. He's tackled heavily. Comes around the corner to Aikens. He's tackled over the band line out of bounds. Boy, oh boy, this is tough and hard in there at the moment.
A little bit happening off the ball between Bailey and Paul Marshall. Getting a little bit of frustration creeping in for the Saints at the moment.
Yeah, well, unfortunately the Saints, they're taking their frustrations out the wrong way as Bailey's shepherded out from under the ball. Hand pass comes out to Clint Lansbury. Kicks it off the ground. Sondergaal, oh, bing, bang, crash. Sondergaal goes into Wayne Deegan and puts him on the deck, and a kick off the ground over the band line out of bounds.
Ooh, that was tough. That was pressure, wasn't it?
Yeah, both came in from opposite angles, and we were just a test of courage there, and neither of them took a backward step.
Bailey out of from the boundary throw, and it'll come there to Brockwell. A hurry kick to half forward to Bryce Marshall. Sondergaal did well to tie it up and stand on his feet and kick it to half forward. Apps in front over the back of the pack. Here comes punting through. He overruns it. He's got support from Beck out the back to Cody. He's under a lot of pressure. It'll come into Apps. He did well. Feeds it off to the running punt and half back and goes across the ground. He's got Rowan Marshall there in the right in the centre of the ground. He quickly turns around and goes on with it wide. He's got Brock Lansbury out on the lead. And will he mark it? It'll bounce in front of him. Lee Atkins right behind him sees it out of bounds for a boundary throw right in front of the social rooms of the Healesville ground. And in the third quarter, we've travelled 7.5 minutes. Several 10-5-65 lead South Belgrave 4-6-30. That is on the ESP Tech Force scoreboard. In we go again with a boundary throw, and Troyan does well. That is Dean from half back, kicks it in the centre of the ground. The race is on. Will Farmer get there first? No. Well done, Piper Casina, through traffic, a hand pass to Punton, a little one over the top. He's got Clint Lansbury. Can he mark it? He dropped the baton to pick up a little one over the top. Only gone just over 10 metres, but he found Wayne Deegan, and that was better from the Saints, and he will line up about 40 metres out directly in front of goal.
Yep, playing a little bit into the several football clubs' hands here, because they used probably 8 possessions just to transfer play from one side of the green to the other, so they're sort of struggling as they get it through.
Wayne Deegan, long shot at goal. I think he pushed it the wrong side of the post. He has a point for South Belgrave. That will take them on to 4-7-31, trailing several 10-5-65 on the ESP Techville scoreboard. 8.5 minutes in the third quarter.
Dean Troyan, the kick out from full back, goes long, out towards half back again. Looking out there for Sondergeld. Deegan came over the top. Tackle that time on Quakerzina by Shane Seager. Underneath, and it goes, and it's going to be a ball up by Angela Mercier. Angela Mercier throws the ball up at half back. Tapped out that time by it looked like Dustin Apps. Coming through to CJ Harrison. Pulled off the ball late that time. CJ Harrison butters up again, kicks into the middle of the ground. Dustin Apps on Jason Leeds. Leeds does well. Kicks the ball around the corner on his non-preferred side that time. Comes out wide. Lenny Melchior dives in. Kicked off the ground over there by South Belgrave. Out towards the wing. Coming through that time was Lee Atkins over there. And it's going to be over the boundary and out of bounds for a boundary throw in. Once again, several into attack. Bailey up against Luke O'Neill over there. Boundary throwing once again. O'Neill got it that time. Punched it towards half back. Sliding in there on top of the ball. Could almost be. No, it's not holding the ball. And Andy LaMercia says, give it to me, boys, and I'll ball it up. Be a brave umpire to pay it in several's forward line, that's for sure. Tim Bailey goes up. Gets the tap down this time. Diving on the ball is Winmark. It comes out once again this time, and Andy LaMercia says, I'm going to have to ball it up again, boys. No, it comes out. Coming through that time. Running out, Goldsworthy. Kicks it out wide. Out towards Brockwell. He's matched up on Eddie Wells. Wells beats him to the ball this time and just sees the ball over the boundary line out of bounds for a boundary throw-in in front of the change rooms here at Healesville.
Seville, real handy lead. They lead by 34 points in this third quarter. In this Division 2 Grand Final, we've travelled 10.5 minutes in this third quarter. Leeds out of the rough, tackled by Apps. They go near the boundary line. We'll have another boundary thrown right at True, nearly up, pushing up the centre wing in this third quarter. And several have skipped away as it to a really handy, appears to be match-winning lead at this stage. 34 points in this Grand Final. There's the boundary throw, and Leeds and Apps have gone at it all. Leeds is getting on top in this quarter. Benny Solder tries to work his way through, can't go anywhere, and we'll have another ball up in the same position, centering on that outer side in front of this big crowd. Conditions, no rain, conditions have been good, and the ground's dried out reasonably well in this third quarter after heavy rain this morning. Umpire Walters, big toss of the ball, throws it up. Apps wins this one out. We've got another big pack of players going nowhere. Near to Brockwell, near the boundary line. CJ Harrison, little Terry has done well, but he runs out of room. We'll have another boundary thrown virtually in the same spot, pushing up towards half forward for South Belgrave in this third quarter. They've got to make something happen for them. The Saints at the moment, they're 34 points down in this grand final. Leeds wins it out again. It'll come out the back to Clint Lansbury. Well done by Sean Wilson. CJ Harrison, terrific.
Oh!
Still on the line. Play on, it's called. It's gone half forward. Farmer feeds a hand pass. Can he pick it up? Oh, big wet patch there, and it's forced out of bounds for a throw in on that outer side. And CJ Harrison, he was crunched up. He kicked it
straight up, though, CJ. He's running down towards the boundary throw in contest again.
All right, but Boundary throwing at half forward, he certainly is, CJ, and he's performed well in this grand final. Over the back, Bailey couldn't get it. It'll come to Apps, he's tackled there. Falls to the ground, in they go hard again. We'll have another ball up, no play on, calls the umpire. And now we will have a ball up, and we've travelled 12 and a half minutes in this third quarter, and Brett Fisher, a handy 34-point lead to Seville.
Yep, Seville's just trying to choke up and waste up a little bit of time and forcing South Belgrave to kick extremely wide and use up options that are pushing out towards the boundary, which is right into their hands.
Bailey got it for that time. Alex Bacon's back in defence. Oh, that's Dustin Apps down there, it is. When he melts you, dives on top of the ball. In there is Richie Fay working hard. So also is his opposition number one in Shane Senior. Goes to the bottom of the pack. Down at the bottom there, it comes out. South Belgrave clear it out of defence. Leading in the race with the balls. Benny Solder, though, he's closed up well on Paul Marshall. He'll get a free kick. Oh, he did get a free kick holding the man that time. Benny Solder. And it comes out to Sonnengeld, who's been excellent for Seville in this quarter. Picks it around the corner, but Dustin Apps played a kick behind the play. Takes the mark. Kicks in long to half forward. Punched away from Brockwell by Eddie Wells. Coming through Sonnengeld again with a bit of guts. Out comes to Goldsworthy. He's tackled. That should have could have almost been holding the ball. Goes over the boundary line out of bounds for a boundary throw in.
What commitment from Eddie Wells in?
It's going to be a free kick to Goldsworthy for a hold up after the contest. He goes in towards goal, but he's missed a lot to kick it out of bounds on the full. This is Alex Bacon was screaming forward at the top of the goal square. It's going to be a free kick for Dean Troyan at full back. He'll take the kick from the back pocket. Will go out wide. No, he doesn't. He plays on and crosses the ball out to the other side to Jason Leeds. He's leading in the race with the ball. In pursuit is some Rowan Marshall. Kicks it off the ground. But Sean Wilson's there for Seville. Oh, tough and hard in there at the moment as it's tackled there. Clint Lansbury gets it on to Brock. Over to Rowan Marshall. He's tackled by Kane Shaw. But it's in there hard at the moment. Marshall picks it up and kicks it in towards the forward line. Biggins at the back. And kick off the ground by Goldsworthy for a goal. That's his second. South Belgrave's first in the quarter. They go on to 5-7-37. Trailing Seville on 10-5-65 on the SP Tech Force scoreboard, 14 and a half minutes gone.
Brett Fisher, reward for effort there.
Yeah, good reward. They had a couple of opportunities. Goldsworthy just out here, he worked the free kick and unfortunately he sprayed it out in the full and, pardon me, Troyan takes the kick. He tries to switch play over to Leeds and Leeds just coughed it up because he missed that first grab and he was away and just pressure from South Belgrave, just edged it forward and then spills out the back. There's Goldsworthy, dangerous forward they've got.
South Belgrave edge closer. They need a couple before three-quarter time with 15 minutes to keep their chances alive in this grand final. Out of the middle, CJ Harrison pull off the ball. Shane Senior, he's hotly pressed there by Brockwell. He goes again for a second effort. Senior tries to break the tackle, but can't go anywhere. We'll have a ball up. Just pushing the forward side of their centre, Seville in this third quarter, 15 and a half minutes in this grand final, and they lead 10-5-65 to South Belgrave 5-7-37 on the ESP Tech 4 scoreboard. There it is, Apps out of the ruck. It'll come down to Cassina, tries to break the tackle, he gets a hand pass, Wilson gets a knockout there for Seville. It comes out the back, in they go, Kane Shaw being terrific in the clinches, goes in hard and ties it up, and we'll have another ball up in the centre of the ground. And Healesville on this big crowd here in this Division 2 Grand Final. Cars ringing the ground, and what a great exhibition it's been so far. Seville with a handy lead in this Grand Final. Leeds goes thump out of the ruck to half forward through Putton. Can he get back? Lenny Melchior misses it. A hand pass will come out to Beck. James Beck on his left side kicks out looking for Paul Marshall. Can he get there? And he does. Takes a really good mark at full speed. Paul Marshall at centre wing quickly on. Kicks it out wide. Looking out here for Bryce Marshall on the lead right near the boundary. He runs out of room and it's out of bounds for a boundary throw and half forward for South Belgrave, about 60 out from their goal in this third quarter, 16 and a half minutes in this grand final. Jason Leeds will go up against Dustin Apps once again. boundary throw in, leads in front, wins it down. Bryce Marshall goes in, but well done there, boy. That was by Stewie Boyce, got it out, the Casino's done well. Goes in board to Brockle with a good pass. He's quick, turns around and quickly on into forward. He's got Deegan out the lead. Will he mark? Crunch, oh, they went at it. Spills out to Bacons, he did well. Alex Bacons around one, but he couldn't, no. Play on, should have been pinged, but they'll turn it over. It's come over from Bailey to Boyce in the middle. Away Boyce, breaks one tackle. The pressure's on, he kicks it to Lenny Melchior, who drops the mark. CJ supporting him at half forward.
Lenny Melchior dives in on top of the ball. It's tough and hard, and the clinches in there, but it's going to be a ball up. And Lee Walter says, give it to me, boys, and I'll just relieve the tension a little bit here. Woohoo! 17 minutes and 20 seconds gone in the third quarter of the Division 2 Grand Final. Bailey goes up in the ruck, but he's beaten for it that time. Senior, his hand pass is cut off by Kazina. Stewie Boyce goes in hard again. Hand pass over the top, comes to Troy Coates. Coates goes inside 50, kick up forward. Good work that time in defence, that time by Daniel Sharp. And just beats Winmar to the punch a little bit, and it goes over the boundary line out of bounds for a boundary throw in.
It was good work, wasn't it, from Daniel Sharp then?
Really good, strong strength work that time by Daniel Sharp, because they needed someone down there who could match it strength-wise with Nicky Winmar. Boundary throw in. Deep in, Seville's forward 50. Timmy Bailey gets the right tap out, but it goes once again and hits the behind post, and it'll be a boundary throw in right next to the behind post for Seville, who are kicking to the dog track end. Really hard work at the moment for both sides out there. Going to be tapped out once again by Bailey, straight in towards the goal square. It's flipped out again. Farmer's in there working hard, kicks the ball off the ground, and Farmer scores a behind for Seville. They go on to 10-6, 66, leading South Belgrave on 5-7-37 on the ASP Tech Force third quarter scoreboard. Brett?
Yep, really putting the pressure on now. Both sides have upped the ante. They can smell the victory coming away 35 minutes away. So South Belgrave are starting to get a little bit panicky, running hard and straight at the footy. This is their final stanza, I believe.
Over the boundary line, out of bounds in the opposite pocket this time, and it's going to be a boundary throw-in. Jason Leeds comes down for this one, as does Dustin Apps. The two combatants go at it again. Boundary throw in. Leeds taps it down to the front of the pack. Down there and under the pack, kicked out of there by South Belgrave. Out of defence. Missed that time by Sean Wilson. Andrew Davies missed it also. Lenny Melchior buttering up at the back. Gets a hand pass out. It's smothered there by Bacons, who kicks it off the ground. But Benny Solder at half back takes a nice mark.
Good mark to Solder, right on his defensive 50 for Seville. He will kick long to centre half forward. Troy Coates in front, thumped away by Punt, and it's Dustin Apps. Stewie Boyce does well at ground level to tie it up now, feed it out the back of the pack. Dustin Apps did well. Tries to feed it out, but he's straight to Leeds. Big pack of players. Bailey tries to sock it off the ground. Punton goes in there. They're skating everywhere at the moment, trying to break clear, but they can't. Finally, they will. South Belgrave kicking in the middle ground where Paul Marshall will mark. Right in the centre of the ground. He's quickly on with it. Unloads in the half forward. Bacon's getting back. It's over, he said. Thumped away by Troyan at the back. Bryce Marshall goes in hard at ground level, tries to feed it out. Well done by Lee Aitkins. He's ripped off the ball, socket off the ground by Goldsworthy towards Eddie Wells and Deegan. Deegan gets here first, hooks it round the body. It's half smothered off the boot, and Sondergeld sees it out of bounds. Good defensive work from Matt Sondergeld for the Seville Football Club. With 20 minutes in this third quarter.
He's been great in this third quarter, Matty Sondergeld, hasn't he, Brett?
Yep, very good. They're just being very dour and defensive and using the boundary line at its maximum. And, very good, cool heads under pressure, the young fellas.
Bacon's out of the ruck, can grab it. Can he now sockers it for out of bounds again? He tried to hook it round soccer style Alex Bacon's, but he couldn't. We'll have another boundary throw in the forward pocket. He's tried hard for him today, Alex Bacon for South Belgrave. He's been moved up forward. Boundary throw in about 3 metres around from the point post in the far right hand pocket. Over the top, it'll come to Wayne Deegan. Can he break clear? No, he can't. Well done by Lee Aitkins. He tries to feed it out. Big pack of players. Clint Lansbury does to Brockwell backwards. He hooks it round up to the top of square. Marshall, that is rolling. It's thumped away to Salter at ground level. Oh, a lot of pressure in there. It'll come out to Sondergeld. He gets a hand pass out to Shane Senior, who can from half back relieve. He goes along the line, out looking for his coach, of pushing the back. No, he's paid the marker. Dustin Apps. Apps has the mark. He unloads it back into the forward zone. Deegan at the back marks. No. Here's Cassina offhands around one, around two, into the goal square. But here's Lenny Melchiori defending for several. Has plenty of time. He releases from the back pocket and goes to the outer side.
Eddie Wells leading in the race for the ball. He showed what sort of pace he's got in that second quarter. Does well. Kicks it along the line. And it's rolling, rolling, rolling out towards the boundary line and stops. Eddie Wells keeps running. Kicks it off the ground to Stewie Boyce. Hand pass to Eddie Wells. Just missed him with a handball. And it finally goes out of bounds. What great work by Eddie Wells that time.
Mate, would have been player of the day if he had got that one back, because he would have ran another 30 metres. There was nothing there for about 60.
Oh, great work that time. Brilliant effort by Eddie Wells. Oh, it's a free kick going the other way this time, and Martin's kicked out towards Paul Marshall on the wing. Deep in the pocket, kicks in long, down towards the forward line. Davies comes out with a head of steam, and it goes over the boundary line. But so it's going to be a free kick for too high for Shane Brockwell.
This is where I call it the panic time for an opposing side. They've moved Deegan now to full forward. They've got the big fella Bacon's at centre half forward now. They're really starting to hit the panic button.
Davies punches the ball away. It goes to Rowan Marshall, but over the boundline, out of bounds for a boundary throw, and the kick in from Brockwell. Wasn't all that flash, and Davies had the chance to keep his eye on it and punch it out. Boundary umpire, ball in his hand right in front of us in the scoreboard here at Hurlsville. Bumped under the ball was Dustin Apps. Kick just inside the boundary line and over and out. The score, Seville 10-5-65, leading South Belgrave 5-7-37 on the ESP Tech Force. Third quarter scoreboard, 23 minutes gone.
If just a South Belgrave can get a goal, it'll make it interesting for that last quarter. Get within the range of about three goals of Seville. It's in their forward pocket, the Saints. Boundary throwing, Leeds gets it out. Big pack of players trying to come through as Griffiths. Glansby off the ground, kicking in danger. Griffith, it's right near the line. Will they reach him? Marshall, will he get a toe poke to it? Bryce Marshall, I think he has on. He's got a goal for South Belgrave, yes. He toe poked it right on the line and socketed it through for another goal. That will take South Belgrave on a 6-7-43. Trailing Seville 10-5-65 on the SP Tech Ball scoreboard. Brett.
High stakes stuff in the last couple of minutes. South Belgrave, they're throwing everything at this. In the last few minutes, they knew they needed to get the next goal, because Seville get that, it's almost game over. So they needed to get it. Now all of a sudden, there is the light just flickers a bit more. So they need to get the next one more before three-quarter time, and they're right back in.
Back in the middle, 22 points down out of the middle. Leeds gets it. It'll come to half forward to Bailey. He's pushed off the ball with dives again. Does well, the big fella. Shane Senior feeds it off to Coates, who breaks it half forward. Hand pass on to CJ Harrison. He can kick it in the pocket, looking for Winmar out in the lead, and finds him, yes. Deep in the pocket, about 40 metres out as the rain starts to come again. And Nicky Winmar, about 40 out. Well, he well in range with Nicky Winmar. Just increased the angle a bit now. That's an important kick in the context of this grand final. Nicky Winmar from about 40 on a 60-degree angle. In he comes off one step, unloads. I tell you what, the umpire has not moved. Nicky Winmar, with his second goal, has extended Seville's lead to 28 points. Brett Fisher.
Well, if ever South Belgrave had the win taken out of this Spinnaker, it was in the shape of the number seven, because not only did it they kick a goal to try and get themselves back into it, but not less than 1 minute later, Nicky Winmar puts them, that just removes that advantage that they may have had. Any chance that South Belgrave have of winning this game of football will come in the next 2.5 to 3 minutes, because they're going to need to kick another goal.
Leeds, it wins the ruck contest again. Goes to the bottom of the pack to Kane Shaw, but he's tied up, and Lee Rowland says, give it to me, boys, and let's start this all over again.
It'll be too big a margin, 5.5 goals at three-quarter time. They need to get that under the five-goal mark to give themselves a chance.
Bailey back in the middle. It comes to Paul Marshall. Kicks it up forward, looking for Bryce, and he takes the mark in front of Matt Sondergill. Great work, Bryce Marshall. Comes in forward, looking up there, been trying, slipped over, but it's got to come back. And it's going to go back to Bryce Marshall at half forwards. He didn't kick over the mark. Goes long, in towards the forward line. Andrew Davies pushed in the back, no free kick. coming through. Alex Bakins does well, kicks around the corner, out of bounds on the full, and that could just about be it, you reckon. And Dean Troy will take a free kick at full back. Working hard, the Seville back line, but they left a few players on their own there, Brett.
Yeah, they did. They've got to be careful. They've just got to keep tying and toil away for the next 2 minutes and 2 seconds. That's the advantage you've got of sitting next to the timekeeper.
Back there's Dean Troyan. Kicks out long, out towards the outer side, towards that clubroom side of the ground. As it comes down to the bottom of the pack, in there working hard again over the band line, out of bounds. Just working it well, tying it up Seville at the moment, not letting South Belgrade get another score. Once again, boundary throw in. Back at the half forward line again, tapped out to the bottom of the pack by Tim Bailey, who punched it straight towards the boundary line, out of bounds for a boundary throw in. Just starting to settle down a little bit at the moment. The last minute and a half of the third quarter. Boundary throw in once again. Bailey up against Rowan Marshall. Tim Bailey wins it out again. It goes straight down to Clint Lansbury for South Belgrave. Hand passed out, looking for a teammate there in Brock Lansbury, but it's gone over the boundary line, out of bounds once again for another boundary throw in.
Yep, they're just going to choke it up now. Seville can smell the siren at three-quarter time, and they're just trying to waste it away. You won't see too much pretty footy in the next minute and a half.
Kane Shaw got the tap out that time. Dustin Apps on half forward, got a hand pass out. Dean Troyan did well. Kick in forward, and Wayne Dugan's taking a mark. 20 metres out on about a 45-degree angle. Great kick in there by Paul Marshall that time. Brilliant work. Just used his pace there, and Dugan just got a little jump on Eddie Wells there and took the mark. Eddie Wells gone back about 3 metres on the mark, so he's got a little bit of a run up there as Dugan comes in now, kicks for goal. Oh, I think he's done pretty well, Wayne Dugan, has he? Looks like a point.
The reaction, I think, the South Belgrade supporters were cheering that one, weren't they?
Point to Wayne Dugan. They go on to 6-8-44, trailing Seville on 11-5-71. But they needed that one, didn't they, Brett?
Oh, yeah, they do. They needed one before three-quarter time. They need to get that one back that Winmar scored.
Dean Troy will get the ball long out of the fence. Goes out towards Shane Senior. Oh, he just had the prop and wait. And Senior takes the mark on half-back.
Shane Senior, good mark there at half-back. Goes, it's touched off the boot. Will go to centre wing. Troy Coates works his way to the front. Sean Wilson, been a good player. Hooks out of the pack around the body. Looking for Lenny Melchior. He couldn't get it through Leeds. But here's Dustin Apps. Runs away and kicks a long ball inside 50. At the back's Troy and thumps it away. For Seville. At ground level is Griffiths. Can he feed it off to Lansbury? Lansbury's under a lot of pressure. Oh, he could be gone. Play on calls the umpire. Bryce Marshall dives in there. Bailey also salted. Dives in there. CJ tries to break through. Oh, was there a high tackle? It'll come to Brockwell. They're letting it go on the umpires. Hooks a high ball. Bakins comes over the top. Can he mark it? No, he can't. It's tough in there. He dives in there again. Alex Bakins tries to thump it further on. Good defence from Lee Akins. He drags it in. Oh, he's been pegged. He dragged it in under him. Brett Fisher, how did you see that one?
Oh, no. Nah. Didn't like it.
And on the siren, it will go to Brock Lansbury. He is 40 metres out directly in front, and the siren is gone. It's three-quarter time after the siren. Lee Akins was pinged for dragging the ball in under him. And the free kick will go to Brock Lansbury. Centre half forward, 40 metres out directly in front. Here comes to South Belgrave after the siren. Shot on goal. Let's wait on it. I think he might have got this. We'll wait and see on the umpire. No, he hasn't. It's a point. Just the wrong side of the post, and boy, what a grand final. And Fui at three-quarter time, the scores are
6-9-45 to South Belgrave, trailing Seville 11-5-71 at three-quarter time. The ball. The South Belgrave guys just have to get the first goal on the board.
All right, we're ready for starting this last quarter with steady rain now pouring in Healesville as the umpire rolls it up, and we're away in this grand final last quarter of the Division 2 season. Away we go. Apps in the ruck, wins it down in there. Big pack of players. They try to feed it out, but no one will have another ball up. No, the umpire lets it go. Still in it goes. comes out to Luke O'Neill for South Belgrade at the back of the pack. He goes forward to Bacons, and Alex Bacons is marked. No, it's Bryce Marshall, sorry. He's marked quickly on. He's looking for Bacons now. Bacons, it's thumped away by Andrew Davies. Did well. Bacons at ground level goes again. Andrew Davies for a second effort along the line. Getting back to Shane Senior. Goes for the safety of the boundary line and finds it with a well-judged kick along the line. And it's out of bounds at half back for Seville and half forward for South Belgrave in this first 40 seconds of the grand final, with Seville leading by 20 points, 10-5-65 to South Belgrave 6-9-45 on the Wirralik Hotel and Bistro scoreboard in this last quarter. There's a throw-in, Rowan Marshall. Oh, he crunched a senior, he did well, he got a kick into the pocket. Up Deegan, up high, off his chest, but well done by Alex Bacons, hooks it round. Across the body, is it scraped in for a point or is it out on the full? It's out on the full, and the free kick in the back pocket will go to Troy in there. That will be for Seville. That will be Dean Troy in the back pocket. He's been a solid defender for the Blues today. 1 minute and 10 seconds in this last quarter. He goes across the goal to Troy Coates, another good player in there. Just slowing it down, Seville. Just playing possession football at the moment, and Coates.
Still early to be doing that.
Yeah, it is
still
a bit.
Got 20 minutes to go.
Yeah, well, longer than that actually. Troy Coates now loads up and goes long to half back. Marshall, Paul couldn't mark it, but the free kick off the ball will go to South Belgrave. It will go to Paul Marshall. Will it? No, it'll go to Brock Lansbury. It's a free kick at half forward, a long way out. He kicks a long ball off one step, deep in their forward line. Up they fly. Deegan tries to take the big one to Griffith at ground level. He's tied up. Ball spills loose. We'll have a ball up at half forward. Yes, we will. And we're 2 minutes into this last quarter of the Division 2 Grand Final.
Andy LaMercia. Deep in South Belgrave's forward line. Balls it up once again. Leeds goes over the top, taps it down to the bottom of the pack. Deegan was in there trying to get the ball out. Comes out this time. Lee Aikens is in there trying hard. Slipping over was Kane Shaw. Hand pass comes out, but it's punched away out of there. But it's going to be a free kick to Seville for a throw. And it's going to go, looks like Ben Solha. He's done a good job on Paul Marshall in the second half, put Ben Solder. Hand pass off to Troyan. Goes out wide, looking for Leeds. Goes over the back of the pack. In there at the bottom of the pack, trying to work hard. And umpire Lee Walters goes in and says, give it to me, boys. Lee Aikens picks himself up off the bottom of the pack. And also, Brock Lansbury goes to the bottom of the pack once again. Tapped out by South Belgrave, kicked off the ground in towards half forward. Shane Senior dives in there working hard also. It looked like it was Shane Brockwell, but he couldn't do anything with it. It's over the boundary line out, and it's once again a ball up by umpire Lee Walters just outside 50. Brett, it's getting pretty tight in there at the moment.
Yeah, it is. They've got Lansbury in the midfield with Brockwell roving and Goldsworthy, so they've got all their best ball-getting players in there. This is the last roll of the dice for South Belgrave. They've got to get a goal every 4 minutes for the rest of the game.
Coming in, but picking the ball up, Clint Lansbury. Hand pass out to Rowan Marshall. Kicked around the corner. Bacon's playing in front. Oh, will Seville rush it through? No, they don't. Lee Aikens kicks it out wide, out towards the boundary line, over for a boundary throw-in, over on the road side of the ground and the tennis court side. It's going to be 3 minutes 57 seconds gone in the final quarter. 10-5-65 Seville, 6-9-45 South Belgrave.
Thanks, Tony Fu. What a grand final we've got here on the Wirralik Hotel Bistro scoreboard. Clint Lansbury, South Belgrave are pressing high one in the pocket, but Kane Shaw sits under, dropped the mark, but goes in again there. A lot of players there, thumped along the line, but Lee Aikens defending wide to the outer side near the barrier line, and he's found it again, Lee Aikens, for the second time, defending well to that outer side, and it's out of bounds about 70 metres from the South Belgrave goal. They've done all the attacking in this first 4.5 minutes of the grand final. Seville lead by 20 points in this grand final. They need a goal, the Saints. There's the boundary throw and it'll come to Leeds. He knocks it out to CJ Harrison. Out the back, he can't get in. There goes Rowan Marshall hard. Boy, they're working hard, the Saints, under the pack, but they just can't clear it out. Paul Marshall in there, and still the umpire lets it go. Clint Lansbury tries to get a half kick. Well done there by CJ Harrison to Salter, but he's pushed out of bounds for another boundary throw-in.
Brent, I just noticed the experience on the Seville forward line. Winmar, Howard, Melchior, Boyce, and Timmy Bailey's just gone up the ground a little bit. Because I tell you what, the youngest bloke on the forward line is Lawrence Farmer.
Yep, stating the bleeding obvious there, old mate. They've got a, probably an average age there of 33, which has been pulled down dramatically by Lawrence Farmer's 19 years old.
Okay, we've got another boundary thrown at half forward as play continued. Big pack of players, and South Belgrave just can't get it out of the congested play in there at half forward for them. There's another boundary thrown. Leeds and Apps. Leeds wins it out over the back of the pack. Goldsworthy dives on it but couldn't get it. Also Troy Coates out the back to Brockwell as he tackled. Play on calls the umpire. They're letting it go today. Hand pass will come out there. Well done by Koski. In board to half forward to Bryce Marshall. Deegan, hand pass off there to Brock Lance. Brianna Clint over the top. Here's a chance for the Saints to Rowan Marshall.
Oh,
great tackle there. Fantastic tackle there to Seville. That was by Matt Sondergold. And then the advantage to Dean Troy. And away goes from half back. He's got Lee Atkins breaking for him. But it's out on the full there. And the free kick will go out that outer side to Griffiths of South Belgrade.
Wow, what a tackle by Sondergold. Rowan Marshall almost into an open goal. The kick comes in. Clint Lansbury takes the mark at half forward. You can see the flashes going off around the ground at the cameras. It's just pretty dark here in Hillsville at the moment. Goes up towards the forward line. In front.
It's
is it a mark?
Yes, it is.
Mark paid to South Belgrade in front. Just waiting to see who it is. Wait till
I think it's Paul Marshall. I believe it's Paul Marshall as marked. It is.
It is Paul Marshall. And he'll take the kick from about 35 metres out on a 45-degree angle.
He got in front of Jason Leeds. He got the first. It went right up in the air, and he got it on the second grab. It was a definite mark, and umpire Walters was right on the spot. Now, this is an important kick. If he kicks this, it's sort of game on.
Well, Paul Marshall comes in. The kick from about 35 out. Kicks. Oh, I think he might have missed. He has. Oh, that is going to hurt him. First score of the final quarter, a point to Paul Marshall. They go on to 6 goals, 10-46 to Seville, 10-5-65. Brett?
Yeah, look, you've got to get them. If they're going to get five shots at goal for this last quarter, they've got to convert each one. They need another five shots now, and they've got to convert every one of them.
Dean Troyan goes out long, out towards the half-back line. Almost a free kick to Seville there. Sondergeld's in there trying hard. Gets a little short kick in, but it's going to be a free kick to Sondergeld for holding the man. He got rid of the ball and was pulled down after he got rid of it. Kick into the middle of the ground. Oh, it's a poor kick. Brockwell's there. Tried to pick the ball up. Couldn't do so, but it's going to be a free kick for two high, and it's going to go to Shane Brockwell in the middle of the ground.
Shane Brockwell, the Saints, doing all the attacking for this 8 minutes of the last quarter with no result. He's got Goldsworthy loose in the middle. Away he goes. Long to the forward line over the back. A top hand Steegan at the fall of ball. Will swing around. Hand pass to Rowan Marshall. He will swing around. He's pulled off the ball across the face of goal. Apps tries to mark. The ball spills loose. Here they go again. Bryce Marshall feeds it back to Paul Marshall. He's pulled off the ball. Great pressure from the Seville defence. Kane Shaw bursts through. Jason Leeds. What a game we got in here. Grand final. Goldsworthy to Brockwell. He lost the ball. He slips over. Oh, great pressure from Seville. And in they go again. Luke O'Neill gets a kick forward again. Here they go again. The Saints bursting out. Is Rowan Marshall. Breaks a tackle. Hand pass out wide to Koski. He's under a lot of pressure. But we'll get the free kick for a high tackle. And boy, Brett Fisher of the Saints. Are they pressing really hard at the moment?
Oh, yeah. They know. This is it. This is their last four. They've got it every time they go inside that 50. They've got to get a score out of it.
All right, it's in the pocket with Bacon's near the ground. Tim Bailey, no, it's Andrew Davies pushed off the ball in the back. No play on, calls the umpire. It's right near the boundary lines. We saw lightning flashing in the background. It's got very dark here in the last quarter. We've travelled 9 minutes in this grand final, and Seville lead by 19 points, 65. Lead South Belgrade 46 on the Warialik Hotel and Bistro scoreboard as the thunder comes. There's the ball up in the back pocket for Seville. Leeds knocks it towards the boundary line. Here's Shane Senior can break. Yes, he can. He will head kick a low ball towards Boyce that threw it. Lawrence Farmer is loose. Can he bend over and pick it up? He does around one. He will straighten up. Hooks it back to Lenny Melchiori at half forward. Can he turn around? He's got Howard on. It'll go over the top to CJ Harrison. Can he mark it? Yes, he's got it, CJ. Runs on a little one to Winmar on the lead. He's marked
got it.
Nicky Winmar, and that was the one they want. They broke from half-back Brett Fisher and took it all. Here's Winmar straight on. He's got Boyce in the goal square. Will he mark it right on the line? And goals! Yes! A goal of Seville. Stuart Boyce. He's second.
That's it.
Game over.
I reckon it's over. Here comes the rain, here comes the thunder and the lightning, and they're just going to flood the ground, and I don't think you'll see another score.
If the rain doesn't flood the ground, that's for sure. Oh, well done that time by Nicky Winmar. Saw Stewie Boyce running to the goal square on his own. And, you know, just the presence of mind to get the ball quickly over the top.
Extremely smart stuff. Lenny Melchior just pushes forward. He's pre-reading what the next move's going to be by Farmer. Chip across again to Mick Howard, who doubled back. Over to CJ Harrison. Goal.
Back in the middle once again, South Belgrave going to attack. Lee Aikens fell over. Oh, it's a throw against Lee Aikens and the free. No, it's not Lee Aikens, it's Benny Solder in there. And it's going to be a free kick to South Belgrave's Paul Marshall. Marshall in the middle, kicks long, looking down there for Deegan. Cutting across to Shane Senior. Hand pass came out. Rowan Marshall stood up, tackled again. But it comes to Dustin Apps, swings the ball around the corner for one behind. Dustin Apps, second score of the final quarter to South Belgrave, two behinds they've kicked for the quarter.
Would break your heart, Brett Fisher, that the South Belgrave attacked for about 9 minutes of that last quarter. Seville had one forward move, goal.
It's just like the old spinnaker pole breaking down on the yacht, the maxi yacht. It really knocks the wind out of your sail.
Coming up to Derwent River in the last straight of the... Sydney to Hobart yacht race, and I reckon we might be out of a boat race here after the game. But it's kicked up. Dustin Apps dropped the mark at half back. It's getting hard to see him down there at the moment. Could have almost been a free kick to Seville. Nothing paid. Kicked off the ground in towards the forward line. Once again, Andrew Davies clears for Seville. Out towards the half back line was Smullen. Comes down to the bottom of the pack once again. And umpire Lee Walter says, "Give it to me, boys, and I'll ball it up." Oh. It's certainly tough and hard in there in the forward line at the moment as Dean Troyan goes back into the goal square on Rowan Marshall. Up there, Jason Leeds, double-fisted punch away. Seville clear it out of there again. Sean Wilson comes through, taps the ball along the boundary line and almost finds it. Yes, he does.
Heavy rain just blowing in.
It's going to be a free kick to Sean Wilson. Heavy rain starting to come across the ground now as...
I think he's
Sean Wilson with cramp, letting Melchior take the kick. Goes long, down the wing, up towards the top of the pack, but Dustin Apps goes up with the long arms and takes the mark.
Yeah, good mark from Apps. He plays on around one from half back, a half kick smothered in the centre of the ground. Shane Senior socks it off the ground backwards. He'll go in again and get it. Can he break the tackle? No, and he's tackled, loses the ball, play on, calls the umpire, and we'll have a ball up at half forward. A lot of pressure on, and the score's Seville 11-5-71. Lead South Belgrave 6-11-47 on the Woorealik Hotel and Bistro scoreboard with 13 minutes in this last quarter of the grand final. Jason Leeds out of the ruck, thumps it. Brockwell near the band line, he stumped, did well, rode the bump, hooks it round the body to half forward, stumped away by Lee Aikens at the backs. Jason Leeds, soccer style in the middle ground, here's Brockwell, boys, he lifted. Boy, he's trying hard for his side, but he couldn't get it there, and he dives in. Laser tackle, ball spills out, boy, the umpire's letting it go today. Hand pass will come out to Apps, a little kick around the corner. We'll find there that he's sharp as Mark. He goes quickly on, out on the lead is Marshall, and he's marked it. That is Bryce has marked at half forward. He slips, he's going to kick, but he straightens up now. Bryce Marshall for South Belgrave has the kick. Long one into the top of the square. Up they fly in front, off hands. Griffiths with the ball, but Seville swooping with Troy and away. He comes from half back, heads for Sean Wilson, but it skids away from him in the rain and out of bounds on that outer side as the wind's blowing up too. You can see the balloon just flow away, and here comes the heavy rain, and with it you would think, Brett Fisher, South Belgrave chances in this grand final.
Yep, I think they're going to get washed away, mate, because, geez, here it comes. Have a look at that. It's hailing down now, and all it's going to do now is make the ground so slippery and the ball as well. So I think this game's just going to peter out now.
Down at the bottom of the pack once again. In and under South Belgrave, still trying to work hard. But there's not much they can do at the moment as the wind is blowing down towards the Seville end of the ground. Everything's going Seville's way, including the free kick. And the free kick's going to go to Lee Aikens, I think, is it? No, it's going to go to Tim Bailey. Tim Bailey now kicks long. Out towards the half back line. Lenny Melchior dives for it, but it bounces and skids and it's gone out of bounds on the full, and the free kick's going to go to Seville, to South Belgrave. Free kick out there as the sun comes out again. Good work that time as it's come out. Down down towards the forward line once again for South Belgrave, but Timmy Bailey, the old experienced man, and it's going to be a free kick to South, is it? It is. Free kick to South Belgrave for holding the man. It's going to go to Brock Lansbury. Lansbury kicks the ball in towards the forward line. Lee Aikens does pretty well. Gets the ball at the bottom of the pack. Paul Marshall kicks it up. Kicks it up forward. They need a score down here at the moment. And it's punched away from Alex Bakens. Over the band line, out of bounds for a boundary throw in. 15 and 3 quarter minutes gone in the final quarter of the Division 2 Grand Final. Seville 11-5-71, leading South Belgrave 6-11-47. Punched down to the front of the pack once again. South Belgrave, Seville working extremely hard in there, and it's gone out of bounds, has it? Well, it's going to be a free kick, and it's going to go down there to Seville. Kicked up in towards the pocket, and a nice mark taken there by Sean Wilson, who slows it down once again.
Sean Wilson at half back in heavy driving run this grand final. Seville going on to a fantastic victory in the grand final this year. Cap off a great year. Still a chance for the Saints at half back. They will go in across the centre. There, they can't make the mark. It'll be there at the fall. The ball is Griffiths. He did well, but he runs into trouble. Hand pass over the top to O'Neill, but good tackle when Aikens, that was by senior Lee Aikens, supports him, kicks a left ball, and the race is on. Here we go. Doug Griffiths leading in the race with the ball, also with Andrew Davies. Well shepherded there. Griffiths, can he run away? And he did well. Good tackle from Andrew Davies then, and he caused a turnover, and that's great effort there. And Shane Senior's mark at centre half back, and Shane Senior's just got better as the game's worn on, hasn't he? For Seville, has the mark, and they're slowing it right down. 7 minutes to go in this grand final. Senior is really slowing now. He'll kick it right near the boundary line, over the back. Farmer, can he mark? No, it's off hands and out of bounds for a boundary throw in. 17 minutes into this last quarter of the grand final. Seville's 71, lead South Belgrave 47. A clear 4 goals in this grand final. Boundary throw in will be Bailey up against, looks like it might be at the back, O'Neill. Bailey wins it down. CJ Harrison spins out of the pack, hand pass to Lawrence Farmer. Sockers along the boundary line. Maybe he can't keep it in. We've got another boundary throw in, pushing up towards us in the scoreboard at half forward. About 70 metres around on the Wurrialik Hotel Bistro scoreboard is Seville 11-5-71, leading South Belgrave 6-11-47. We're nearly 18 minutes in this last quarter. It's O'Neill in the ruck, but Bailey will come over the back. Yes, he does. Thumps it down to Lawrence Farmer near the boundary line. Tries to just paddle along. He does, and it's forced out of bounds off Jarman for a boundary throw right in front of us. We've travelled 18 minutes in this last quarter.
Scott Troyan on the ground now for I think he's about 32nd run for the day. He started on the ground, he's going to finish on the ground. Up in the ruck, Troyan got it down to the bottom of the pack. Rockwell kicks it out wide. Lansbury, he's met heavily. Oh, Shane Seat. Troy Coates knocks over Chris Koski. It goes out towards the boundary line. Was it over? No, it wasn't. Daniel Starr runs away, touches the ball down once, twice, runs toward half forward. Oh, he's going to be tackled, is he? Yes, he is. It comes out to Brockwell. Kazina kicks around the corner. Marked there by Paul Marshall. Not 10 metres, play on. Hand pass out towards the boundary. And pushed over the boundary and out of bounds was Kane Shaw over there. Just about Seville's best player today. You'd almost say he's done a lot of hard work, but dummies, and a boundary throw in. Up in the ruck, Bailey. Pushed out of it that time. Is he going to get a free kick? Yes, he is, King Bailey, and he'll take the free kick and slow it right down with experience, and he'll take the kick from almost a wing. Brett?
Yep, it's not going to be pretty the last 5.5 minutes, mate, but I think they're just playing with a time out now, Seville. They're going to kill it to the boundary each and every time, and South Belgrave are just banging their head against the wall as they try to get it forward.
Paul Marshall kicks the ball up forward, but Shane Senior takes the mark. Hand pass off to Dean Troyan. He goes long into the middle. Stewie Boyce is in space. Falls over in the middle of the ground, but he should be paid the mark anyway. Oh, he had heaps of room there, Stewie Boyce too, and he could have run on. Kicks high, Jason Leeds, ducks back, takes the mark. 45 metres out directly in front.
He's a fair way. Wouldn't this be a fitting result if the Jim Wyman medalist could nail this one? He's a fair way out here in front. He's sent half forward.
20 minutes gone.
Wouldn't it be a fitting result if Jason Leeds could nail this goal and seal the premiership for the Seville Football Club?
Yep, I... I think he sealed anyway, but yeah. This would actually parcel it up and post it.
Yep. Jason Leeds, the coach, the captain, the Jim Wandon medalist. He's got just about everything this year, and he's going to get a premiership medal as well. And the premiership cup to take back the saddle tonight.
I like Shane Senior here. I reckon he's got a good chance to win this footy.
Jason Leeds comes in. Kicks from about 48 metres out. Goes right to the line. Hits the post. Oh, you would have ridden that home for a week. Jason Leeds, one goal, one for the game. That takes them on to 11 goals, 6.72. 6.11, 47 to South Belgrave.
All right, Seville.
On the Wooi Ellicott Hotel and Bisbee, final quarter score.
21 minutes, Seville are going to go and record a magnificent victory in this grand final. Be premiers for the season 2003. Apps from half back, hand pass off there. In trouble, the players are tired now. It gets kicked to Casino at centre wing, away he runs. Straightens up, Craig Casino kicks long into the forward line. Over the back is a chance for O'Neill, but getting back his team. Troyan does well, hooks it around the corner towards the boundary line, towards Lee Aitkins. Lee Aitkins will get the ball at half back. He goes further on along the line. Players are tired in these conditions. They're heavy now, and it's out of bounds at half forward for South Belgrave. Now the free kick will come back to Sean Wilson for Seville. He's been a good player all day. And they've been a very, very even team performance from the Blues today. He unloads with a long torpedo over the back, off hands, Apps, down to Stewie Boyce over the top. Here's Lawrence Farmer. Can he grab it at half forward? Bounce for him. Yes, he can. He feigns one onto his left, straightens up on his left side, pushed. Too far, according to umpire Walters. He just went that step too far. And the free kick will come back to South Belgrave at half back. And he just ran a step too far for Lawrence Farmer for Seville. We've travelled 22 minutes in this last call, and the free kick will go to Beck. That is for South Belgrave. That is James Beck at half back, and away goes and hits that outer side. A long kick. Here's Leeds over top. 1-2. Nilly took a good mark. In they go at ground level. Feed it out the back. No one can get it. It's tough in their playing calls. The umpire, they dive in it. We'll have a ball up on the outer side, right in front of the social rooms there. And Seville, Tony Fu, are going to go on a magnificent victory.
They certainly are. And Seville's going to go all the way from 22 and a half minutes gone. We've got about 3 minutes to go on the final quarter. Scotty Troyan got the ruck contest knockout that time, but it's once again at the bottom of the pack. And Andrew Mercier says, give it to me, boys, and I'll ball it up. Don't do anything stupid now, boys, in the pack. And Andrew Mercier will just throw the ball up in the air. He does. Getting the punch away was Rowan Marshall. As the rain starts to tumble down again, down to the bottom of the pack, Lee Aitkins is working hard in there. Gets it out towards Jason Leeds. He's working hard as well. And yet again, another ball up. This is just the way Seville want it. 2.5 minutes to go in the Division 2 Grand Final. Seville are going to record a huge victory. Down to the bottom of the pack once again. Out wide. And once again, Andrew Mercier says, okay, boys, I'll practice my ball-ups again for the last time this year, and I'll throw it up once again.
Nothing too tactful for the rest of the game here, mate. They're going to get home comfortably, and it won't be too flash for the last couple of minutes.
Tim Bailey got the ruck contest knockout down to the bottom of the pack again. Free kick to South Belgrave this time, and that is going to go to Lee Goldsworthy. Goldsworthy goes in long, down towards the forward line, over the back of the pack. Davies punches the ball away once again. Kicking the ball off the ground was Paul Marshall. In towards goal, stops right on the line, and Andrew Davies says, thank you very much, boys, and I'll clear it and back through from behind.
He did it well, didn't he?
6-12-48 to South Belgrave, 11-6-72 to Seville. Three behinds, Brett Fisher, for the last quarter to South Belgrave, where they wanted goals.
Yeah, look, they've had their fair share of ball inside the 50 there, but they just haven't had the opportunity to convert it. Every time it's gone in, it's skidded in, and within that 25-metre arc, they've been well under pressure.
Troy Coates back in the middle this time. He's done pulled off the ball without it, but it comes down to the back, and down there taking the mark is James Beck, finishing off Wardy.
James Beck for South Belgrave. Kicks out wide to Dustin Apps, and credit to this guy. He's tried hard up against a lot of odds. He marks and runs on, kicks it in there, looking for Casey Myers. It's too far for him, but he can run it down. No, he can't. Oh, great pressure from Seville. Well done there by Bryce Marshall. Brings it in, centres it up, and there's a good mark there to Paul Marshall. Well done, and also credit to this guy. He's tried hard all day too. But unfortunately, the Saints, they just haven't been good enough, and Seville will take the honours. Now, Marshall would be about 35 out Directly in front of goal on line up for South Belgrade's first goal of the last quarter. Paul Marshall, in he comes. Kick on goal, it's pushing across, and he's missed to the wrong side again. Another point to South Belgrade will take them on to 6-13-49 to 7-11-6-72 on the Royal Lake Hotel and Bistro scoreboard, and that is 17 scoring shots to Seville and 19 to South Belgrade. So there you go, they've had more scoring shots. The kick out from fullback has found Tim Bailey, and he's just going to say, I'm going to slow it right down here for the Seville Football Club in driving rain with 20 seconds left in this grand final. The Blues will have a magnificent victory as Lee Atkins is marked in the centre of the ground. He goes wide out there to the other side. Oh, good mark to Lawrence Farmer. We've got about 10 seconds. A little one over the top looking for Sean Wilson. He's marked. Has he? No. 1-2. Play on goal. There's a siren. And Seville are the premiers. And look at him come. A fantastic effort. Seville are the premiers in Division 2 for season 2003. And Tony Fu, the final score.
Seville, 11-6-72, defeated South Belgrade, 6-13-49, and Seville, premiers for 2003, and they are going to have one heck of a time tonight.
And they certainly are, and Brett Fisher, a really good performance from Seville Football Club.
Oh, great performance. They, the old fellas, actually, you know, arguably I'd put it down to the old fellas winning the game for them, because just the experience that they showed throughout the game, and held their heads and held the young fellas together when South Belgrave had a crack in the first half of the first quarter, and through a couple of undisciplined acts, you know, Seville get the last two goals in the minute leading up to quarter time, and that actually give them the impetus to push on and go on. That doesn't happen. South Belgrave go into quarter time two goals up, and you know, their tails in the airs, and everything else can change. So, you know, arguably a one undisciplined act ain't going to cost you a game, but gee.
And just a credit to all the guys here and the guys behind the scenes and all three of them stand over the back there as well. That's what typical of